This is the home of the Oklahoma State Cowboys, the scene of what is billed as the most exciting offensive game in the country today, as the 21st-ranked Baylor Bears and the 17th-ranked Oklahoma State Cowboys battle for the number one spot in the Big 12 South Division.
We have a young team, but we have a lot of drive and a lot of great leadership on both sides of the football.
Oklahoma State is the second highest scoring offensive machine in the nation. The visiting Baylor Bears are led by RG3, Robert Griffin, a superstar QB who is third in the nation in total offense.
I'm feeling invincible tonight. I'm alive, take a look into my eyes.
Start your engines. 21st-ranked Baylor battles the 17th-ranked Oklahoma State Cowboys. The Big 12 Shootout starts now.
A beautiful day in Stillwater, Oklahoma, as we proudly welcome you to Big 12 College Football Saturday, presented by Academy Sports and Outdoors. This morning, Big 12 South Showdown as the 21st-ranked Baylor Bears face the 17th-rated Oklahoma State Cowboys. It is the crazy Big 12 South with Baylor, the leader. Oklahoma and Oklahoma State tied for second coming into this game here today. Welcome, everyone. Bill Land alongside Dave Lapham. It doesn't get any better than this, Dave. No. And we've got two outstanding teams head-to-head. You might be surprised that they're here fighting for first, but no mystery as to why they're here with powerful offenses.
They're balanced. Both can run it. Both can throw it. Both have kicking games that can dictate field position. The key is what defense will avoid mistakes and make plays.
And for Baylor Bears, they've got a balanced ball club, but no question who the leader is. It's Robert Griffin.
Robert Griffin is a dynamic quarterback. I mean, this guy makes big plays out of bad plays. He manufactures time and space. He's a dual threat dynamo, a right-handed Michael Vick. He could be a key in the running game as well as the passing game, but he's going to be handing the ball off to Jade Finley a lot. Look at those numbers in the last 3 weeks. Crazy. Averaging almost 9.5 yards a carry. A downhill ball carrier that finds space in small creases, and he can hurt you when he squares those shoulder pads up.
Now on the other side for Oklahoma State, you got Brandon Weeden, his first year as a starting quarterback. This guy's an outstanding thrower. If he's not hitting, though, he's got options in Kendall Hunter.
Well, this guy has got a strong throwing arm and tremendous accuracy. He makes the deep ball throws into very tight windows, lets his receivers make contested catches. But he's going to give the ball to Kendall Hunter a bunch. Kendall Hunter always had the agility, the change of direction. But this year, he's a different running back in that he will actually get the tough yards for you. I mean, this guy is going to run through arm tackles. You're going to have to wrap him up and gang tackle him. He will push the pile this season. Watch this. Not one, not two, not three. He is going to make you tackle him with a bunch of people to get him to the ground.
The big fella's fired up. I am as well. We hope you are. Stay with us. Special teams are big, too. Emily Jones will have that in a moment. We come back. We go to the studio on Big 12 College Football.
Welcome back to Big 12 College Football Saturday, an absolutely glorious day for football in Stillwater, Oklahoma. The Baylor Bears in town to take on the Oklahoma State Cowboys in a battle for positioning atop the Big 12 South standings. And we know about the offenses in this one, and they do grab the headlines, but it may be the special teams that end up stealing the show. And we begin our focus on the legs of the Baylor Bears. The place kicker, Aaron Jones, 17 of 21 in field goals, including two from 50 plus yards out. And there's the punter, Derek Epperson, the reigning Big 12 Player of the Week, thanks to an absolutely stellar performance last week against Texas, in which he averaged 57 yards a punt. And not to be outdone are the special teams of the Oklahoma State Cowboys. And when you look at their punter, he had a pretty decent week as well last week against Kansas State. Quinn Sharp, four punts all inside the 10-yard line. And when the Cowboys get in field goal range, Dan Bailey is pretty much automatic. 16 for 16 in field goals this season. He's got two of his own from 50 yards and beyond. And also, too, He is absolutely perfect in his career in point after touchdown. So it should be a great game. Special teams-wise, we all know about the offenses, but the coaches say this one could come down to specials. We do know that it will be a beautiful day for football here in Stillwater. We've got the kickoff for you coming up next on Big 12 College Football Saturday.
Welcome back. Boone Pickens Stadium, the site. Number 21 Baylor versus number 17 Oklahoma State. Art Briles, the architect of the Baylor turnaround, 15-18 in his third year at Baylor. He had great success when he was at Houston before coming up to the Baylor Bears in Waco. And after a pair of 4-8 seasons, he's now got him at 7-2, ranked number 21, 4-1 in the Big 12 South, on top alone for the moment. Half game ahead of Mike Gundy's Cowboys, as Gundy in his sixth year here with Oklahoma State. Last year, 9-4, they went 6-2 in the Big 12, the best mark under Gundy in their Big 12 history. But he has improved their record in the Big 12 every year that he has been here, and had them headed in the right direction as they roll in number 17 in the nation, 7-1 overall and 3-1 in conference play. Their only loss to Nebraska here a couple of weeks ago. Baylor's only loss in conference play came, you were at the game in Dallas at the Cotton Bowl when Texas Tech edged them in a wild one.
Yeah, in Oklahoma State, 25-9 in their last 34 football games. Pretty good.
Glad to have you with us, and as always, presented in HD. Here we go, the kickoff, and it comes to Baylor after winning the toss, and Baker is tackled inside the 20-yard line. And the Baylor Bears will have it first. They won the coin toss, no deferral.
Got a penalty flag on the return, probably some kind of illegal block or a hold of some sort.
18-yard return. Let's see if it stands.
During the return, illegal block in the back. Return team, number 2, 10-yard penalty, first down.
Well, we already talked about special teams dictating field position. Special team problem dictating negative field position for Baylor. Great coverage by Oklahoma State. And then in the process, Baylor commits a penalty. Here they have a very, very poor starting spot for their first drive of the game.
That pushes them back just inside the 10-yard for Robert Griffin III, the sophomore from Cypress Cove, Texas, who has thrown for 7 touchdowns, rather for 20 touchdowns, 1 for 7, a true dual threat.
And he's only thrown 5 interceptions, too.
Yeah, he's become such a much better passer. He comes out firing right away, completes it to Gordon. Gordon gets that lost yardage back in a hurry before he's knocked out of bounds around the 24-yard line. The tackle is made by Uri Lemon.
And this is what Baylor does, Bill. They try to create space both inside and outside for their athletic wideouts. Yards after catch, huge.
Gordon, big playmaker, 29 receptions now. He has 7 touchdowns this year. They come back on the quick look to Wright, and Wright makes the reception. He steps out of bounds near the 34-yard line, and Justin Jent makes the stop there. And both teams, we're going to see a lot of plays today, aren't we?
Up-tempo, no huddle, catch your breath while you can, because they're going.
And it's 2nd and 1 for the Bears. Fake on the run, and again, Gordon got the first down. And again, knocked out of bounds. And we'll take a look now at your starting lineups brought to you by Phillips Televisions. And there's the offensive line. Watkins, the big leader for this bunch. We mentioned Gordon. Wright is their leading receiver, though. And of course, the quarterback, Robert Griffin.
And Bill, the wide receivers that don't handle the football do such a great job without the ball in their hands. Terrence Williams threw a great block on that bubble screen. Wide receivers help wide receivers. They're almost like extra linemen out on the perimeter. We have an injured Oklahoma State football player.
Down for the Cowboys is Roderick Brown, sophomore from Houston.
Boy, both of these offenses are competing at such a high, high level. It's going to be key to get them out of, disrupt their rhythm and timing. Let's see the knee right there to the back. That'll hurt. That's going to leave a mark.
So while they attend to Broderick Brown, we'll take a brief timeout with Mike Gundy's Cowboys and the Baylor Bears just underway. Following the injury, we are ready to go again as Baylor at the 40, just shy of the 45-yard line, a 1st and 10 from the Bears 45.
Justin Gilbert in at corner. Will they go after him?
Griffin, play action, going deep, and
incomplete. Nearest man to the football was Justin Gilbert, the defender.
They went after him. He comes in for the injured Broderick Brown. They try to take him down the football field. Wide receiver and quarterback on different pages.
Phillips Television bringing you the defensive line starters as well as the backers. Lemon, the leader there. Thomas, outstanding last week. In fact, had a defensive touchdown as well as a couple of other huge plays.
Both teams, Bill, have dynamic football players at the safety spots. I mean, that's the leader of the pack for both defensive units.
Second down and 10 for Griffin. Bobbled and then finally caught as Terrence Williams, the sophomore receiver, is brought down by Gent. Picks up a couple of yards, still shy of midfield, though.
Gent came on the blitz, and that's a pretty good job. Bill Young mixing things up. Sometimes he rushes three, sometimes he rushes four. He's going to mix it up and try to get Robert Griffin out of his rhythm and timing.
See Griffin's phenomenal numbers, and now the crowd gets into it as it's a third down situation. Needing six for the first down for Griffin. Finley with him in the backfield. Two wideouts each side. Griffin has to adjust, nearly picked off on that play as Lemon was sniffing it out. They'll kick it away here, and we'll see the first of the special teams after the kickoff and the effect that the kickers can have in this one.
Watch the twist up front right here, and they come clean. A little tackle end twist, pressure on Griffin. He has to throw the football with his mechanics not structurally sound as he's moving to his left, throw it back across his body in the middle of the football field. Pressure helped cause that incompletion. Oklahoma State getting after it up front.
Epperson, there are the numbers. 45.6 for Derek Epperson, the senior from Southlake, Texas. Josh Cooper, the return man for the Cowboys, takes it on the four, made one miss, got a block. And Cooper is brought down shy of the 20-yard line at around the 19. And we'll take a look at Phillips Television's presenting the starters here after that 46-yard punt. And for OSU, the big fellas up front have done an outstanding job all season for Mike Gundy's ball club. Hunter, Blackmon, the nation's leading receiver who was suspended last week, is back and ready to go this week. The Cowboys survived his absence, winning at Kansas State 24-14, while Baylor bumped off Texas in Austin last week 30-22.
Blackmon's back.
Weeden out of the backfield. Hunter fumbled it, but out of play. Close to a first down as he rambles near the 28-yard line.
What that is, Bill, is an extension of the running game. A little circle route out of the backfield, check it down to Hunter, get the ball in his hands in space. It's like a long lateral. It gets Weeden at first completion of the game, too. Gets his feet in the ground.
Johnson on the tackle. Second down and one. Weeden hands it off on the draw. Hunter slides up across the 35 to the 36-yard line. First down, OSU, as we take a look at Phillips Television's presentation of the defensive group. Taylor has been big. Chadwick's filling in for an injured player. And in the secondary, Landor is unquestionably the leader. Number three in the conference in tackles with 91. Now they come right back on the ground. Joseph Randall, who was impressive last week while getting some reps in place of Hunter and sometimes with him. Randall has run for 310 yards this season. And last week, he ran for 64. He had four receptions for 59.
And he's averaging over 13 yards per catch. That's his 20th catch of the season, a threat out of the backfield.
Picked up five. It's second and five. Weeden. Hunter still trying to catch his balance as he caught that ball going side to side. Is tackled at the 41-yard line. Third down coming up for OSU.
What a great tackle by Johnson in space. Linebacker on running back. Staggered a little bit. Hunter doesn't have the ball out in front of him, but that's one-on-one in space. Nice job, Antonio Johnson, being an athlete.
Third and five. Weeden finds Blackmon. Blackmon broke one and easily. First down and into Baylor territory at the 49-yard line. Justin Blackmon came in with now 63 catches. Atchison makes the tackle. Well, he picks up 10 there.
Watch him right here. Now, a little bubble screen. You know, it sounds silly, but the way he catches the football, he just plucks it. It's effortless. An unbelievable receiver.
Weeden, a couple of fakes rolling out. Going to keep it. Got room to run. 35 and out of bounds around the 30-yard line. Brandon Weeden, remember last week he scrambled once for about 8 yards. Prior to that, he's been pretty much a pocket guy or get rid of it.
It was a little misdirection, and Baylor bit on it big time. Watch the action here of the reverse. They bite in the reverse. Look at everybody start to pursue. Here comes Weeden. He's got a couple of big boys out in front. There's only one defender. Holy mackerel, there's a lot of green out there for Weeden. He tucks it and goes.
19 yards, his longest run of the season. Weeden here on first and 10. Delivers again. And the Cowboys are sharp from the opening gun as Chelf makes the reception. Stevenson making the tackle for Baylor.
Both offenses are so well put together. Creative, nice pickup on the twist up front. Protections there for Weeden. Vision totally unimpeded, and he throws it with some vigor and accuracy. Now he's got some. He can spin it.
Nation's third leading scoring team, averaging 45 a game, on the doorstep here. Kendall Hunter finally hit a rock named Landor inside the 10-yard line, though. It'll be first down and goal for the Pokes.
Well, you talk about a sure tackle. Landor one-on-one in space. Boom, see ya. That's the end of the journey. Take him backwards. Byron Landor, that's a man right there. He brought out his big boy pads.
Flag is thrown here after that 13-yard pickup.
12 men in the huddle. Now, you don't want to take those penalties in the red zone, Bill. You work so hard to gain all this real estate, and this is the most valuable real estate when you're inside the 20. You don't want to give 5 yards of it back. And I'll tell you, there's an unhappy Dana Holgerson right there.
Yeah, the offensive coordinator of the Cowboys in his first year has just made this team so powerful. Mike Gundy, you saw as well, not happy at all with that call. Sets it back, and it's still first and goal, but outside the 10 now. And Randall is thrown to the ground at the 15-yard line. Not much of a gain there for Joseph Randall, the freshman out of Wichita, Kansas.
You know, one of the big keys in this football game with these explosive offenses is when you get in the red zone, score touchdowns. Don't settle for field goals. Who's going to execute when the field gets compressed? It's going to be a track meet between the 20s. Defense is going to bend but not break. Who's going to finish drive?
You see the Cowboys in the red zone and what they do. Second in the nation in red zone scoring. First in the Big 12. And this one, pitch out to Cooper. Cooper takes it down near the 7-yard line, brought down by Tyler Stevenson.
When you're at converting almost 70% of the time in the red zone for touchdown, that dog will hunt. I mean, you're getting a lot of things done. And the key in the red zone is to be able to run the football, but you have to stay ahead of the chains. You can't be second and third and long in the red zone and expect to be able to run it.
Third and goal for Oklahoma State. From the 7. Kendall Hunter. Hunter stuffed by that Baylor line as Tevin Elliott leads the way. And remember last week for Baylor, one of their keys, and they actually had to come from Miami Beach, Texas, they gave up field goals, not touchdowns. It appears they've done the same thing here.
They gave up one touchdown to Texas and 5 field goals. Little inside zone going on here. And look at the Baylor get off blocks and gang tackle. Baylor is the ultimate bend but don't break defense. And on the flip side of it, Dana Holgerson saying, Bailey, he's perfect on the season, 16 for 16. We know we're going to get 3. Let's not put it in jeopardy and turn it over.
So Bailey trying to stay perfect. Line up, kick this one, which is like a long extra point, and it is good. So the Cowboys strike first on the opening possession for Oklahoma State as Dan Bailey makes it a 3-0 game. Dan Bailey's 23-yard field goal has put the Cowboys on top. Here on just a glorious day for college football in Stillwater, Oklahoma. Bill Land, Dave Lapham, Emily Jones, and the crew with you. Glad to have you aboard here today as Baylor will get ready to receive the kick following the Cowboys' first possession that stalled after 12 plays, 75 yards, and took 5-11 off the clock. Weeden is 5 of 5 for 36 yards, and he also ran it for 19.
Not a bad first drive for the 27-year-old.
And the kickoff for Oklahoma State going to Baker. And they'll let it go and come out to the 20. The kickers are doing their job here. What about keys to the game here for Baylor?
Well, Art Browse and the Bears want to play with a lead. They're not right now. The first score was accomplished by Oklahoma State. Now the Cowboy fans will be in full throat. He wants to get big plays. He had three of them for touchdowns last week against Texas. Three plays for 158 yards. The other 65 plays, just 160 yards. But those big plays are key, and then he wants to be balanced, be able to run it and throw it. Let's take a look at what Oklahoma State wants to do. They want takeaways, not giveaways. They've got 22 takeaways, seventh best in the country. And they want to continue that. They want to get seven in the red zone, not three. They didn't do that in their first drive. And hidden yards, field position. They want to win the battle of field position. Baylor at the 20 on this drive. They started the first drive inside their 10. They've been going long field.
Griffin hands off on first down here. And Lemon makes the tackle on the play. Jay Finley. Finley, senior out of Corsicana, Texas, has really come around. The last three games, he's rushed for over 500 yards and averaged over 9 yards a carry to give him those season totals that puts him seventh overall in the Big 12. Griffin on the rollout and out of bounds. Griffin averaging 4.4 a carry. He's run for over 400 yards this season, tackled by Lemon.
Well, Finley has seen the good, the bad, and the ugly. There's no question about it. And since RG3 has come on campus, it's been good. And this young man, Finley, has persevered. And now he's got a quarterback that can make plays as a dual threat dynamo, and his life is so much easier. They complement each other so well. Finley will get you those tough yards between the tackles, run behind those pads with a low pad level, and thunk you.
Ran for 116 in Austin last weekend in the win over Texas. He's battled injuries, as Dave mentioned. He has really shown some determination and perseverance. Had 865 yards in his sophomore year. And not much doing here. Did he get it? Looks like. Got across the 30. And yes, it'll be a first down. Lemon making the tackle.
Boy, Lemon squeezed Finley big time on that one. I mean, it was a super bear hug squeeze. How about, ooh, little contact right there. Take him to the ground, Mr. Lemon. Holy mackerel.
Both these defenses have been torched a couple of times this season. Oklahoma State allows 407 yards a game. That's seventh in the league. And Baylor average has given up 390. That is sixth in the Big 12. But they've gotten better over the course of the season.
And they're on the field for a lot of snaps.
Griffin quickly steps out of bounds at the 35-yard line, picks up around 4 or 5, and Jeff was there to contain him. And I guess that's about all you can try to do when he decides to run.
Exactly. And staying with the Lemon theme, Ori Lemon, Robert Griffin makes lemonade out of lemons. I mean, when it's a bad play situation, he creates a good play. He makes something out of nothing with his jackhammer feet and athleticism.
But coming off the knee surgery where he missed most of last year and granted a red shirt, he's more mature, and this guy's already been very smart, makes better decisions, doesn't run at the first hint now, passes it out here to Gordon.
Ball's out.
Cowboys have it. Oklahoma State recovers. Oh, wait a minute. No, they're still giving it to Cowboys. I thought for a minute they're going to call him down, but that's not the case.
Well, we talked about a key to the game for Oklahoma State. Take the ball away. Don't give it away. 22 takeaways on the year coming in. Make it 23. Leading the Big 12 Conference, seventh best in the country. And there's no question that this is a takeaway. And just a good job. Back in the fray, recovering from that injury, is Broderick Brown. He rips it out of there. And Oklahoma State comes up with, watch him just rake it out of there. A violent rip of the football. Ball security's key. You got to put it away. Oklahoma State makes him pay.
Terrific play by Brown. And now Randall comes back on the running end for OSU. He's hit by a swarm, but picks up 4 or 5 as he is stopped at the 32-yard line.
And you don't want to give up short fields. Right now, Baylor, there are two drives. They started at the 20 and at the 9. And now look at the drive start for Oklahoma State, courtesy turnover. They're winning the hidden yards big time.
Now Kendall Hunter back in the backfield. Weeden. Nice comeback reception by Michael Harrison. And Harrison picks up the first down as he is stopped at the 25-yard line of the Bears. Johnson there for Baylor.
Michael Harrison has star written all over him. This young man runs good routes. He's a freshman, 6'1", 212 pounds. Look at the comeback route he runs there, gets separation. That's the way to get in and out of your cut.
He's got breakout ability. There's waiting for it to happen. That's his 10th reception of the season. Blackmon went off without the football, came back to pick it up.
Antonio
missed a touchdown.
Yeah, Antonio Johnson stripped it, Bill. He's out there one-on-one. Antonio Johnson makes a great play and punches the ball out of there. Watch this. Just rips it out of there. Now he comes back to pick it up and can't get to the house. But just an outstanding effort in space. Hey, ball security guys, put that thing away. Treat it like gold.
He picks up 6 yards, but he was thinking I had touchdown number 15. And Hunter stopped by Phil Taylor, the Baylor defensive tackle, goes 340 pounds.
Yeah, they're big up front in the middle, Bill. Jean-Baptiste, 6'1", 330. Phil Taylor, 6'4", 340. Man, Shevitz, that's tough to get some push interior, that line right there. These two guys, that's like a couple of refrigerators.
When you go to Waco, you always check with them on dinner plans.
Absolutely.
They know they won't let you down. Right up the middle, look at this, Jeremy Smith. He takes it all the way to the 5-yard line. The redshirt freshman from Tulsa, just his 24th carry of the season. Atchison makes the tackle after an 11-yard gain.
I'll tell you, kudos offensive line. Nice job up front. Take a bow, Parker Graham. That's a way to get to the next level and get a block. This Oklahoma State offensive line plays as a unit, all five guys. It's like the June Taylor Dancers.
Now they pass in the end zone looking for Blackmon. He's got it.
Touchdown.
Touchdown, Cowboys. They had to wait. OSU picks up another 6. Stevenson was covered.
Side judge had to take a look, Bill. Did he have possession of the football? And all you need is 1 foot down, inbounds in college football. Catch, right foot down, left foot down too. And he's running position. He collects himself. The side judge says, you know what? It's a good play. Let me make sure in my mind. Yeah, that's a touchdown. What a play. They're going to review it. They're going to take a good hard look at it. Now, did Blackmon have full possession when he had that right foot inbounds? Did he have possession? Did he get the left foot down? It doesn't matter if the right foot was down. Okay, right foot. Is it down with possession of the football? Catch, right foot down, left foot out. But is the right foot down with possession? Had he secured possession? You have to have ball and 1 foot down. And talk about putting the ball in a tight window. Brandon Weeden just dropped it in a tight window. I mean, that's a perfect throw. The only guy who can make a play on it was his All-American candidate wide receiver Blackmon. Catch, right foot down, touchdown. Great play by Justin Blackmon, but even better throw by Brandon Weeden. I mean, that's good on both ends of it.
Blackmon gets his 15th touchdown of the year, and if indeed it stands. And for Brandon Weeden, who's now 8 of 8, 54 yards, and Weeden, that would be touchdown pass number 24 this season.
Right, and that second in the country, Bill, with 23 touchdown passes coming in. Third in yards, second in touchdowns. Weeden is just lighting it up. And you talk about accuracy. My goodness, his accuracy to all parts of the field.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed, touchdown.
That's called body control. Justin Blackmon has a lot of abilities. He competes, he attacks the football in great shape cardiovascularly, and he has body control for contested catches and awareness where he is on the football field. I'll tell you, he's special.
Here's Bailey, who has not missed a PAT in his career. 175 of 175, 44-44 this season. And you can't do any better than what this guy's been doing this year.
Mr. Perfect.
Yeah, hadn't missed one extra point or the field goal. And it's good. And the Cowboys lead it 10-0 now. After the break, we'll check in with John Rattigan for an Academy Sports and Outdoors game break. Thank you, John. What a ball game there in the Big Ten between the Illini and the Wolverines. Right here, yeah, Blackmon is the guy as he gets the TD reception, and Oklahoma State, the short drive that took just 2:06 following the turnover, the fumble recovery. Now the Cowboys with Quinn Sharp to kick it off to Baylor, and the Bears find themselves down 10-0, 4:10 to go first quarter.
65 catches for Blackmon, 15 of them touchdowns. Not a bad ratio.
Baker takes it, downs it in the end zone. And it'll come out first to 10 at the 20-yard line. And well, you mentioned before, Boy, who's going to blink first in this game? Well, blink being a turnover, right. It was Baylor.
Yep, Oklahoma State's defense made the first big play, and they've been dominating field position. Three drives for Baylor, two start at the 20 on touchbacks, one starts inside the 10 on good coverage of a kickoff and a penalty. So Baylor has had to go long field. Oklahoma State, courtesy of the turnover, short field. Everything's falling into place for the Cowboys right now. Big drive for Baylor. Will they show resiliency like they've shown all year? Huge drive. They got to get it, cut it to a one-score game.
Yeah, and at least give their defense a chance to kind of regroup a little bit here. Hopefully flip the field. Finley, tough run up the middle across the 25-yard line. And for Jay Finley, tackled by Johnny Thomas out of Texas City, Texas, in the secondary. First and 10 line is brought to you by Phillips Televisions.
Where Johnny Thomas is playing at a very high level. These safeties are fun to watch on both teams today.
Second and four, outside and knocked out of bounds on the play for Baylor. Broderick Brown again making the play on Reese.
Reese and Sampson threw a great block for him. I'll tell you, these bubble screens, stock blocking, Baylor puts on a clinic with their receivers, how to stock block opposition defenders in their bubble screen game.
Reese coming in with 33 grabs for 300 yards and sets up a third and one for Baylor.
Look, they got spread the field. There's seven in the box right now. Will they hammer it inside with Finley?
That's the call. He tries to bounce it outside. Not going there. Chinasa, Nicholas, and crew all over it.
Bill Young said, hey, we're coming after you, getting off blocks. Don't let Finley square his shoulder pads up the line of scrimmage. Look, oh, he turns into the sideline. Now he's running east and west. Now he's just a guy. When he comes downhill and those shoulder pads are squared up and you get him to linebacker level, he will hurt you. But you make him run east and west toward the bench area.
Well, be careful. We're in Stillwater. East and west here is
yeah, right,
a little bit different
right.
deal. One of the
sideways.
Few stadiums.
How about
that's
that?
Right.
Make them run sideways instead of downhill.
We want to be proper.
I need my compass.
You'll see that sun become a factor later in the game because of the way the field is set up. The kick and Cowboys stay away from it. Nicely done by Epperson. Got a good roll as well. Takes it down to the 22-yard line. And let's send it down to Emily Jones.
Well, guys, Bill Young's defense getting it done so far today. And in talking to him over the course of the season, he said he did seek out the input and advice of some of the other defensive coordinators and coaches who have coached alongside Dana Holgorsen and opposite this system. He said it does definitely have an impact on the defense that you run because you're seeing anywhere from an average of 15 to 25 more plays per game on defense. And so that's definitely something that they've had to consider when installing this new offense here at Oklahoma State.
Bingo, Emily. They were on the field 97 snaps and Weeden whiffed. The ball came out of Weeden's hands. That's a fumble, and he falls on it. Heads up play. Don't anticipate it being an incompletion. He lost control of the football in his throwing motion, but he's
a balk from his pitching days.
Yeah, empty hand. Whoa, empty hand. Exactly. He said, I've done this before. I've been on the mountain and had problems. And little nonchalant in the pocket. That's not the pitcher's mound. That's the pocket in the football game.
Signed with the Yankees in 02, traded L.A. Boy, has he made the transition back to football. Pitch and catch here. Nicely done to Bowling. 40. Bowling slides across midfield. We'll see where they mark it. Shy of the 50 at the 48. Stopped by Tim Atchison.
Well, Bowling made Lander miss. He made the best tackler for Baylor miss. Watch on the sideline. Blitz pickup is made. Watch this. Lander, uh-oh, you got to use the sideline as the 12th man. Took a bad angle.
They come right back to Randall. He drops the football. Yes, that was a forward pass, so it's incomplete. You know, Bowling was one of the guys who stepped up in Blackman's absence last week when he had 8 grabs.
Yeah, and he's bowling for dollars right here. He's money. Because look at Byron Lander. Took a bad angle, didn't use the sideline as the 12th man to squeeze Bowling. And Bowling said, I'm going to make you pay. Nice little pirouette inside. Looked like a little ballerina with balance there getting up the sideline.
Senior from Tonko, Oklahoma, came in with 20 catches, again, 8 of them for 92 yards last week in Manhattan.
Look at quads down here.
Weeden, till that drop, 9 of 9 for 86 yards. Going to the air again, and this one. Anyway, misunderstanding there.
Yep.
He was turning what direction?
Absolutely. He had his All-American candidate wideout Weeden coverage one way, Blackmon went inside, Weeden threw it outside. Different page. Not only different page, different volume of Encyclopedia Britannica.
You saw Dana Holgorsen there. Really no secrets when you talk about these two teams, what Emily was talking about. Holgorsen, of course, was at Texas Tech, and Art Briles was at Texas Tech for an assistant 1 year, and so was Briles' defensive coordinator, Brian Norwood.
Yeah, absolutely.
So everybody on each side know a lot of what's going on. Weeden back to Bowler. Nearly tripped and then kept his balance before he is stopped at the 44-yard line of Baylor.
Bowling does a good job of balancing himself, getting that left arm down and tripodding himself to keep himself upright. Watch, he cleared up a little shallow cross. Here comes Bowling. Watch the balance. Oh, 50-yard line, almost made an unassisted tackle, but he balanced himself up.
Fourth down now. Cowboys show that they're going to go for it. Fourth and three, just inside the 45.
If the Baylor defense can rise up, it's like a takeaway.
They fake to Hunter. Weeden wants it all right here, going deep.
Uh-huh.
Blackmon, oh my! He's shaking his head. So are about 50,000 in orange here at the stadium. Can't believe it.
He had Clifton Odom beaten, and Weeden couldn't have thrown the ball any better. I'm not sure if the sun was a factor or not. The shadows are changing. But this ball, you talk about deep ball accuracy, it is right on the money. I mean, Blackmon catches that 99 times out of 100. That's the one time the star did not finish. I mean, he is a touchdown maker, and that was a touchdown pass. What a change of events. That could have put them up big time.
Yeah.
Now what it is a takeaway. Baylor gets the football at the 45-yard line. Circle that play. A touchdown pass of 45 yards becomes nothing, and Baylor gets the ball at the 45-yard line. Huge momentum swing.
Great call by Dana Holgorsen, and Weeden executed, and a rarity that Blackmon didn't. Now, Baylor wanting it all.
Ooh.
And incomplete, intended for Cooper, or they're for Gordon, I should say, Josh Gordon, and
Brown
a chance to get six.
Yeah, Broderick Brown recovered to the football because RG3 threw it a little bit short, underthrown slightly. If he gets the ball out there a little further, I don't think you can overthrow Josh Gordon. This guy has jets in his shoes. I mean, you just let it fly as far as you can because he can run everything down. And he got underthrown right there. He absolutely torched it down the field.
So second and 10 for Baylor. Excellent field position after getting it on downs. Flag thrown, somebody jumped. Yep, that's Baylor.
Dead ball, false start. Offense, number 79, 5-yard penalty, still second down.
And that's Robert T. Griffin. That's not the quarterback, that's the big Robert Griffin. And I'm talking big man.
300 big.
Yeah, and you know what, he moves around pretty good.
6'6". Euless Trinity, the Navarro Junior College.
He eclipses the sun.
So now it is second down and 15. Across the middle, a little high that time for the intended receiver, Kendall Wright, who's their big playmaker. He's got 6 touchdown receptions, came in with 51 grabs. Lemon covering.
Well, he ran a little twist up front again to Oklahoma State, and Rickety Jones got free on the twist inside and got a hit on Robert Griffin. Baylor's offensive line has to shore up the protection a little bit. Oklahoma State is doing a little twisting and stunning up front, and it's hurting the fellas.
So third and 15 now. 3-man rush. Griffin has time. Still looking and going deep. Flag thrown, incomplete. Intended for Josh Gordon.
Now let's see. We're down the field. The flag. Is there an illegal contact or is it interference? The ball wasn't in the air where the flag was thrown. It may be a defensive hold. See what the call is. As receivers downfield, did he push off? Could be a couple of things. Looks like it's OPI, offensive pass interference, potentially.
20 seconds to go here in the quarter.
Yeah, offensive pass interference. He pushed off.
Pass interference, offense, number 12. Penalty is declined, fourth down.
So Baylor misses a great opportunity. They get fortunate on the stop, but they can't do anything with it with good field position.
Josh Flash Gordon pushed off a little bit to get separation. RG3 tries to go up the football field to get him the ball, but he had already been penalized for trying to get an advantage and separating in his route.
Cooper is back. He's taken one for a touchdown this year, Josh Cooper. Epperson again, who had a 50-yarder last time, will boot this one away. And fair catch, and they'll take over there at the 20.
Bill Young has to be proud of his defense. They don't get the 45-yard touchdown pass. Baylor gets the football in good field position. His defense gives him nothing and get the ball back for that offense. Bill Young's defense is playing at a very high level right now. They had their best game of the season last week against Kansas State. They only allowed 3.9 yards per play. And they're starting to come together.
And as you look on now, Brian Norwood saying, all right, our guys are going to have to step up. It'll be first and 10 at the 20. After a 41-yard punt by Epperson, Randall goes in motion for Weeden this time. Weeden has been red hot. To Randall. Got a block.
Oh, did he?
And Randall rolls for a first down.
Oh, man, I'll tell you, take a bow, Jonathan Rush. That's a hit. Hopefully he's okay, but it was totally legal contact. Francis got drilled. And right now he's trying to see, make sure he knows what's happening, but watch the block right here. Watch this block. Oh, there it is. Watch the block inside. Jonathan Rush absolutely detonates Francis. Watch this. Peel him off. Whoa! I mean, and that's a good aiming point. Hits him right in the midsection. Didn't go helmet to helmet. Boy, he stroked him.
He takes a quick breather as that ends the first quarter. And Oklahoma State, very impressive. That's the end of the first quarter. Cowboys lead it 10-0. You're watching Big 12 College Football Saturday. It's presented by Academy Sports and Outdoors. Our ING direct timeout and our game summary. Take a look here. Weeden just about flawless, 11 of 14. They've about doubled Baylor in yardage, Dave. And that fumble was huge.
Yeah, almost a football field in yards more than Baylor's got. The fumble was big. But how about if he has that 45-yard completion to Blackmon for a touchdown? He's 12 of 14 for 151 and two touchdowns. Crazy.
And here they get the ball again to start the second quarter. First and 10. And Kendall Hunter, who in the first quarter had 25 yards rushing. Finley had 12 for Baylor. Griffin threw for 45 yards on 6 of 11 in their first quarter of action. Francis making the tackle here after getting knocked loopy the last time.
I'll tell you, he did a nice job. Avoid the block, and the block was missed by Jeremy Smith, and he put himself right in the hole and made the play. Game's important to him.
Picks up 4 for Hunter. Second and 6 for the Cowboys. Weeden. Bowling. And came back to get the football and did get the first down as he was stopped at the 44, and that'll move the chains.
Nice job by Weeden of field awareness as he stepped up in the pocket, flirting with the line of scrimmage, knew that he had not crossed that line of scrimmage, and he said, you know, I'm not paid to run it, I'm paid to throw it on scholarship. I think I'll get rid of it.
And first and 10 now. Just get underway in the second period. Brandon Weeden dancing around. Got a man wide open.
Yes, sir.
Blackmon saying, let me go. Hanging on was Landor, who stops it from getting the touchdown at the 18-yard line.
And he's hurt. He goes to the sideline. His right shoulder is in trouble. He's in big trouble. And they blow this, blow the play dead the next play. But watch this one. Down the football field, Lander gets in the play, and he hurts himself on the hit, holding on for dear life. He gets up and goes right to the sideline. Here's Blackmon, and watch. He's my quarterback. Here I am. Find me. Look at Lander. Recover.
How's that happen?
I mean, that's a blown coverage. Totally blown by Baylor. Lander, touchdown-saving tackle. Let's see if it saves his team 7, 4, or 3 points.
He's got arguably the best in the country, and they couldn't find him. Bowling wheels down inside the 5-yard line. Landor being attended to. Yep. Big 12 Defensive Player of the Week. 31 tackles the last two games. Was a monster in that Texas win.
Oh, he got up after that hit on Blackmon, holding on for dear life. That shows you his toughness. He's got one arm holding on for dear life. Blackmon goes to the ground. He gets up and just exits right to the bench to get medical attention.
14-yard pickup on that play, and it's first and goal. Hunter ran into his own, comes off of it, almost squirts in, and is stopped down inside the two. Kevin Elliott makes the tackle against Kendall Hunter. Hunter, who's got 12 touchdowns on the ground this year.
Boy, I'll tell you, Oklahoma State can really make a statement here if they punch this in into the end zone and go up three big scores, 17-0.
Second and goal from the 2-yard line for Oklahoma State.
Inverted wishbone.
Right up the middle. Hunter, no sign yet. Still waiting as they unpile. Nope. He was held that time.
Well, it starts with the two D tackles. We talked about them. You got 340 and 330, and they get off blocks, and they reestablish the line of scrimmage backwards. It's hard to get movement on the blocks of granite up the gut.
Third down and goal from the one. Hunter again. No denying him that time. Touchdown, Oklahoma State. Flag is thrown.
Was there a face mask on the tackle? Looked like somebody get up by his headgear as they were bringing him to the ground.
And now players are getting into it a little bit.
Let's see if somebody grabs that grill. And there it is. That's the face mask. Get up high, grab the grill, and that's a big one. That's 15. It'll probably be enforced on the kickoff.
Yeah.
I mean, you got to call that one because neck injuries can happen there. I mean, he tackled him by the face mask. And that's what we're talking about, Hunter, with the tough yards, the physical yards, running through tackles, finishing runs. He's always had that change of direction, the agility. Now he's complete.
Personal foul, face mask by the defense. Penalty will enforce on the ensuing kickoff.
And that's going to, I mean, Oklahoma State at that point, I wouldn't just kick it through the end zone. I'd do like a little directional pooch kick and try to pin him inside the 20. You know, don't just blast it through the end zone. Well, you're going to be kicking off, you know, from basically on their side of the field, Baylor's side of the football field. Play a little game with them and try to play field position.
Bailey, as expected, good again. 17-0 Oklahoma State on the first place showdown in the South Division. There's a scoring drive, 8 plays and 80 yards. Hunter caps it off with a touchdown. Cowboys 17-0. Baylor coming in here ranked number 21 and bowl eligible for the first time since 94. And Art Briles on the turnaround, he says, "You guys have worked so hard, patted on the head so long, it's nice to have a seat at the table." And well, now that you're at the table, you got to show you can eat.
Yeah. Well, they came from behind on the road against Colorado, came from behind on the road against Texas. Now they're going to have to come from behind on the road in Stillwater, down 17 points to a prolific offense. This is the toughest test yet for Art Briles and his football team. 231 yards offense for Oklahoma State to 65. And look at the plays and the time of possession. Oklahoma State's playing keep away.
And I understand Briles' feeling there. So long, people saying, "Hey, you're trying hard, you're looking good, you're getting better." And then they'd almost under their breath say, "Boy, I wish we played you next week."
Yeah.
That's not the case anymore with this Baylor program, as they have turned things around. But now they are in a tough situation here with 12-19 to go in the half. And after that penalty, of course, they kicked that one all the way to the athletic center. It'll be first to 10 from the 20. Let's send it down to Emily Jones.
Well, guys, Byron Lander is done being evaluated on the sideline. That right shoulder was being looked at. He has rejoined the defense back on the bench. Expect to see him back on the next Baylor defensive stand. As far as the talk on the Baylor bench, the need to communicate is being stressed heavily as of right now.
Yeah, Emily, it might have been one of those stingers. You know, you get that stinger and your arm burns, goes numb, and then it goes away.
Finley on the first down handoff takes it across the 25-yard line for Baylor. Jay Finley, take a look again at Lander on that play.
Let's take a look at the hit he makes on Blackmon, and he hits. See his neck, his head and neck, and he gets. Sometimes you pinch a nerve, you get a little stinger. That right arm is burning right now. And look at him, and he gets up, and then he exits stage left, right to the sideline immediately. There he goes. He's leaving, going to the sideline for medical attention. Tough kid. Finish the play. Not going to let him go. He's going to hang on.
Second and 4. Griffin delayed, hands off to Finley. Finley, tough run, trying to get the first down and stopped by Johnny Thomas.
Boy, Robert T. Griffin, the big right guard, got himself a pancake block, put some syrup on that bad boy. Finley getting to the perimeter, Say, if Griffin wanted to keep it and tuck it up inside, he might have gotten even more yardage. Those guys do a good job at the last minute of deciding. Ride him, ride him, ride him. Let him keep it or pull it out of there.
There you see the first four possessions and how unproductive it's been for Baylor. Finley got the first down. Now Griffin tackled for a loss on the play. Knifing through was Nicholas. Nigel Nicholas, the sophomore from Rossville, Georgia, makes the play.
Well, what you got to do is you have to, nobody, that's a breakdown of assignment. Two guys go for the linebacker, nobody blocks the down lineman. What is it, Alphonse Gaston? You know, you got him, no, I got him, no, nobody's got him. Nobody blocks the down lineman. Now, those two, the left guard and left tackle, were responsible for linebacker and defensive tackle, but nobody touched the D tackle, and they both went to the linebacker. As a result, you're off schedule behind the chains. They're making physical and mental errors up front. Baylor, uncharacteristically, is not being efficient with their offensive line that's played at a high level all year.
And it's second and 13 now. Dave, you were talking before the game. You also get in this new configured stadium here at Boone Pickens. It's much louder,
yep,
tougher to hear things, harder to communicate. Griffin, nothing doing there. Just has to tuck it under and get out of bounds. And Oklahoma State's defense ready to play, and they have really played well considering how well they played last week, and they're carrying over week to week.
They really are. They're put together five, now into the sixth good quarter of football. And like Emily was talking about on the completion to Blackmon, there was just a breakdown in coverage, and that's about communication. Which safety is going to be rolling deep? Who do I have behind me? They just let Blackmon go at the linebacker and cornerback level, and there's no safety deep, lack of communication that she was talking about.
So Griffin now faced with a third and 15. Good protection, zips it across the middle and has the first down, and that should give him a lift. Kendall Wright with the reception. Wright had 5 for 54 and a touchdown against the Longhorns.
Now here, you're the quarterback, nice protection, vision unimpeded, throw a frozen rope that you can hang your clothes on. Oh, drop. Like the smush.
Second down and 10 coming up. Baylor with a hurry up offense, and both these teams, we're going to see a lot of plays today with the up-tempo style.
And a flag on the field, see what this is all about. But that ball hit Williams right in the hands. Williams had one of the big plays against Texas last week, a 59-yard slant that he broke a tackle and went to the house.
Prior to the snap, dead ball, illegal substitution by the defense, 5-yard penalty, still first down.
That's the second time Oklahoma has been hurt. They were called 12 men in the formation offensively. Now they had illegal substitution, 12 men on the field defensively, having some problems getting things right from sideline to the field of play.
So Oklahoma State Cowboys with a penalty. It makes it a first and 5 now. And the handoff, and Finley burst up the middle, takes it down near the 43. Sean Lewis, the tackle, chain mover for the Bears.
Nice job, Blake. Look at the lead block. A dynamic lead block right there by K'Ron Johnson, 300-pound fullback, like another lineman.
He is a big one. Reese, and he takes the quick pitch and catch, goes inside the 40 down to the 37. Tevin Reese, and Baylor may have a little something going now. First and 10 line is brought to you by Phillips Televisions. It'll be a second down and 5 for the Bears.
You got to get some points on the board on this drive. Down 3 scores on the road in a very, very tough environment to play. You can't let it slip away from you any further.
On the 37, Cowboys showing blitz. Griffin goes out in the flat. Oh, bang, bang, play there on an incompletion. Markell Martin delivered the hit.
Did he ever? He came up, and the blitz was picked up well. Oklahoma State declared. Both linebackers came up in the A gap between center and guard. Baylor picked it up. Griffin got the ball out, but Martin said, "I see you," and he closed on it.
So third and 5 now for Baylor. Empty backfield. Griffin under center. And it is complete. Yes, and taken there by Kendall Wright. That ball was bobbled. Both guys go into the field, and McGee covering on the play.
Kendall Wright makes the contested catch. Look at him go airborne.
forward pass.
They called interference. They said they're going to take that flag off. It was a complete forward pass or incomplete forward pass. They say when he went to the ground, did not maintain possession as he went to the ground. You see the ball bounce out. Does he catch it? Oh, he could have gotten it a second time. Let's see if the ball hits the ground or not. The ball squirts out of there. When he rolls, does he have? I think they got to take another look at that. I'm not sure the ball hit the ground. Bodies took it airborne. Kendall Wright says, I had control of that. He fought for the contested catch. They got to take another look at this because I'm not sure the tip of the football hit the ground at all.
The Baylor head coach is challenging the ruling on the field of an incompleted forward pass.
Good call by Art Briles. Got to have this play because it's 17-0.
There is no foul for delay of game. The timeout came prior to the request.
Now let's the ball just hits bodies. I'm not sure if it bounces up from the ground or not.
Certainly touched the leg of McGee.
Yeah, it hit McGee's leg, but does it hit the ground? Look, there contested catch right McGee. Go to the ground. Where's the football? It's here's the ball. It's never hit the ground. I mean, it's up in the body area. And then they kick, as they roll, it's kicked over. That's a catch. Kendall Wright catches the football. I mean, all he did was make a great play on a deflected football. That's Baylor football. That's a good play by Kendall Wright. Look at the athleticism. That's picturesque. I mean, great shot by the guys, and that slow motion is unbelievable. It's poetry in motion right there. And to make a play and to have the focus and to finish that play is a star on the forehead of Kendall Wright, big time.
Wright, who had a touchdown last week, and he had two in the Kansas State win where they had a score fest against the Wildcats before they won that game 47-42. And boy, they need something good here, Dave, because even though it's still 8:43 to go in the second quarter, it's been all Oklahoma State.
Now, I'm not sure if Kendall Wright is a catch yet, does he? If that's his first catch of the game, that's a spectacular one to catch in 34 straight games. He has a catch in 33 straight games coming in, every game that he started. So if that's his first catch of today, he's got one, but
he's got one, yeah.
But that what a play by Kendall Wright. He had that 30-yard slant last week against Texas. I mean, he's got six catches of 50 yards or more in his career. He'll make the spectacular catch, and he'll make the little plays for you. He does it all, and they want to get him involved early in every football game.
Here's the review.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands as an incompleted
pass. Wow.
Baylor will be charged. Timeout.
Got to be, Dave, because they didn't see enough video evidence to overturn that call. I think had they ruled it as a completion,
right. It
probably would have stayed as a completion, don't you think?
Let's see where it touches the ground in their estimation. And they squeeze between the bodies. Where does it touch the ground? And then he catches it. I don't know. I mean, if the ball squeezed between the two bodies, I personally do not see that hitting the ground. But you're right, Bill. If they had called it catch on the field, it would have probably stayed as well. That's why the call on the field is so important, because you have to have indisputable evidence to overturn it. Amazing.
Fourth down and 5, and Baylor will go for it here.
And it cost Art Briles a timeout.
Griffin goes right back to Wright, and he makes a nice grab here in traffic, and that will move the chain. So people say, well, what did we all sit through that for? Great play, though, to pick it up.
Well, they would have had the ball in better field position inside the 20. And how about the amnesia? You have to have short memory, both Griffin and Wright. They got a play taken away from them in their estimation. They go right back and connect again. Tell you, this football team, Baylor Bears, do have resiliency and bounce back ability.
Certainly shown that. Griffin on a 1st and 10. He's got time here. Going in the end zone, out of play, looking for Wright.
Little double move. Oklahoma State does not buy on it whatsoever. Little pump fake by RG3. Oklahoma State, great coverage on that play. No opportunity for Kendall Wright. He has to take a little bit of a breather.
Bears, who come in 7-2, their league loss to Texas Tech. The only other loss was to TCU. Speaking of the Frogs, they got a big one today against Utah.
Yeah, huge game. BCS implications all over that one.
And it's 2nd down and 10. Finley, no. Griffin keeps instead. Goes forward for a couple. And Hugo Chinasa makes the tackle, the senior from Richardson, Texas, out of Bertner High School there in the Dallas area.
One thing defenses want to do is contain Griffin, not only in the passing game in the pocket, but in the running game. They want to contain him and get him on the ground.
Third down and nine, and Griffin flips it out of the backfield this time. Oh. And complete, nearly a first down, loose ball.
Was his knee down when the ball came out? Did he come down with the ball first? Little Edwin Moses-like, hurtling over the pile of players. Great effort. Ball security's the deal. Trying to unpile it. Tug of war goes on now, Bill. I've been in these. The first guy that has a football doesn't normally end up with it. I mean, you're pulling and tugging and biting and scratching. Strong hands, wrists, and forearms win this battle. Oklahoma State saying they've got it. Their players saying they've got it.
And it is Oklahoma State football.
Too bad, because it's a great effort. Just trying to, the little Edwin Moses up and over. Now, the ball's out before he goes to the ground. That's a nice effort, stripping the ball out by Sean Lewis, the dynamic playmaker at linebacker. Watch 11 right here in the orange jersey come up and punch at the football. The ball's out, no question it's a fumble. And Oklahoma State comes up with it.
Thomas, I think.
Robert T. Griffin, the big fella, dove for it, could not get it. Second takeaway by Oklahoma State. They've now got 24 takeaways on the season. Very, very opportunistic defense.
Jay Finley unable to hang on after a terrific run, going for second and third effort. And now the Cowboys get it right back, and Weeden hands it off on first and 10 to Kendall Hunter. 35, Hunter drags one with him out across to the 40-yard line. Hicks makes the tackle.
There's an old saying, Bill, two takeaways you're in, four you win. And right now, Oklahoma State has two takeaways, and they're in. I mean, they're in the house. Are they going to be able to live there and camp out there? They get two more takeaways, they probably will.
22-yard pickup for Kendall Hunter on that play. Hunter, 9 for 55 today. And
flea flicker.
Weeden going deep for Blackmon. He dropped the football. A flag is thrown.
They're going to call interference. They'll get 15 yards out of it, but Weeden made Blackmon stop to come back for the football. If he could have gotten the ball out a little further, just like Josh Gordon, when Griffin underthrew Gordon right here, it's almost impossible to underthrow him. Air it out. Don't put so much air under it. A little bit.
Pass interference. Defense, number 21, 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
And that's Clifton Odom. Gets early contact well before the arrival of football. Blackmon almost makes a contested catch still. I mean, he goes airborne, and Odom can't even keep him on the ground. I mean, he's so powerful, and he's so aggressive. Every ball that's in the air, he thinks is his.
So the Cowboys pick up the penalty of 15 and come right back to the ground game. And Randall stopped in his tracks that time by Tim Atchison, but he still picks up a couple, gets to the 40 of Baylor.
Yeah, so far Oklahoma State's defense has been a big story in this football game. You know, which defense was going to make the big play and avoid the big mistake? Baylor has made some big mistakes in coverage. Oklahoma State's defense has made big plays and takeaways.
Weeden throws this one to Blackmon. Blackmon hangs on for another first down around the 33. Odom covering on the play there.
Well, Coach Gundy was marveling at this kid's cardiovascular system. He's the Energizer Bunny. He just keeps going and going and going, gets stronger as the fourth quarter rolls along. He is a machine.
He's not one of those receivers, makes a couple plays and says, all right, give me a breather and I'll come back in. He just wants to stay on the field and he can handle it.
He's not tapping out.
Look at him again. Nice catch by Blackmon as he takes it inside the 20, this time from Weeden. And Baker covering on the play, or trying to, I should say. And how about big plays? That just a 12-yarder. Look at what he's done this season. And remember, he missed the Kansas State game last week for suspension.
Yeah, every single game he's caught a football for at least 40 yards. Every single game he's played in, including today. Uh-oh. Little extracurricular going on down there on the field, separated by the officials.
Prior to snap, false start. Offense, number 75, 5-yard penalty. Still first down.
That's the second time, Bill, that they've had a penalty in the red zone. And when you get in the red zone, you don't want to give those penalties up.
Blackmon today, 6 receptions for 81 yards. As Weeden and crew, 1st and 15 now.
Oh, he would have had if he caught that 45-yard touchdown. He dropped that 45-yard touchdown.
Weeden drills here. Blackmon slides inside the 5 on the receiving end. That'll be another Cowboy first down, 1st and goal at the 4.
When you have a guy like Blackmon on 3rd down and in the red zone, he becomes a huge target. And look at him run a great route, and he takes it to the post. I mean, it's tough to go out there one-on-one coverage. That time, Baker couldn't stand up to it.
Blackmon, last game, had 157 yards receiving, 2 touchdowns against Nebraska, as Kendall Hunter pushing it forward. And
he's in.
Wait for the signal.
Nope. Signal at the 1-yard line, half-yard line. But talk about pushing the pile like they talked about.
Yeah.
How he can do that now. I mean, he ends up on his back over the goal line, but where did his body come down? And look at him push the pile of big people. He just keeps those legs driving, and the ball in his upper body crossed the goal line, but his lower body, they ruled down before he crossed it.
5'8", 200-pounder sets it up. 2nd and goal to go. And Hunter, wait a minute, whistle first.
Prior to the snap, first charge timeout. Oklahoma State.
Same Cowboys Oklahoma called State. Timeout. Mike Gundy's saying, no, I didn't. And we'll take a break. We'll be right back. 17-0 Cowboys. Oklahoma State on that timeout situation. The play clock was about to expire, and thus the timeout granted just before. And so they will come back, and it will be 2nd and goal from the 1-yard line.
And Oklahoma State was upset about the timeout being granted, but if it wasn't, they would have been penalized to the 6-yard line with the delay of game because of the play clock expiring. So as the snap of the ball occurred, though, Kendall Hunter walks into the end zone.
Apparently, we have a challenge here from the previous play, and whether or not Hunter got in, that OSU would be challenging.
I thought it was a timeout, though. It's a moot point, isn't it?
Maybe this is as much why Mike Gundy wanted the timeout.
And there's no question he scored. Are they trying to determine if the play clock was expiring or if the timeout was granted? I don't know what they're challenging there. The play before, Kendall
Hunter. The play before.
Okay, yeah, Kendall Hunter, was he down? Was his butt on the ground before the ball crossed the point of the goal line? When I saw it from up top here, I thought he had crossed the goal line. They ruled his buttocks hit the field of play before the ball crossed, but his butt's at the half-yard line. So if his butt hit down there, he's not carrying the ball down by his butt. I think he's got the. Let's take a look here. As he spins to his to go to drive into the end zone on his back, the surge, the push. Boy, yeah, the ball is down. The ball is down, and the ball is short of the goal line. That's a good call by the officials.
That might explain, if we're trying to read people's minds here, why Mike Gundy was calling timeout originally. Was it he wanted to appeal the previous play?
Right.
He wasn't concerned about the play clock as much as he wanted to make sure he got his timeout called so they could review this play.
Exactly. That's exactly it, Bill. You know, it wasn't reviewed by the official. He thought that he did score. He wanted to make sure, like the play that was appealed by Baylor on the catch, non-catch Kendall Wright, they burned a timeout to ask.
Right.
You can do that. You can challenge one. And Oklahoma State's challenging this one. I don't think this one's going to be overturned.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. The runner was short of the goal line.
So now we get all that sorted out, and it will be second down and goal.
What they were upset about was they were yelling timeout, asking for timeout, and the official wasn't granting it. And they were getting ready to snap the other play. It's like, wow, how loud do we have to yell? How do we get your attention? We're going to come down and grab you, I guess.
So 2nd and goal from the 1. Weeden again with Hunter behind him. And deja vu all over again, Yogi. This one is in. They've signaled touchdown, and Cowboys get on the board again. So Hunter gets his 2nd TD of the day. It just took a while.
Yeah, exactly. It took a while. It all ends up being a moot point because watch these guys surge off the line of scrimmage. Look at that. That's some pretty stuff. I mean, they stand all the white jerseys up and take them back across the goal line. And the easy part is Kendall Hunter's job. The big boys up front create the crease for Kendall Hunter to take advantage of, and they live vicariously through his touchdown success.
Dan Bailey, the senior from Mustang, Oklahoma, with the PAT, and he stays perfect on the season. It's 24-0. All season long, Champion Apparel will be showcasing the history and traditions of the Big 12 Conference. Today, we highlight Oklahoma State. Champion, it's how you play. John Rannigan. Here in Stillwater, Oklahoma, Cowboys rolling 24-0. Kendall Hunter, a pair of touchdowns on 1 yard runs for the Pokes, and he's got 14 TDs on the season now as Oklahoma State prepares to kick it off to the Baylor Bears. Bill Land, Dave Lapham, Emily Jones with you on a beautiful day here, but it's turned ugly for Baylor, and the triplets have been hard at work.
You really have. You know, Dana Holgorsen was worried about the chemistry and timing between Weeden and Blackmon. Well, it's intact. Blackmon dropped a 45-yard touchdown, but it wasn't because of timing.
This one sails through the end zone as Quinn Sharp takes care of business on the kickoff. And now Baylor once again will get it first and 10 on the 20. And there's the crowd from Waco and the Baylor fans that have made the trek up I-35 and come here to Stillwater as their club at 7-2. You know, their first time they've been bowl eligible since 95 when they went 74. They didn't get a bid that year, though.
Right.
They last played in the 94 Alamo Bowl when they lost to Washington State. That's when Chuck Reedy was there. And in fact, Mike Gundy spent a year under Chuck Reedy as the passing coordinator at Baylor before he moved on, eventually came back here to Oklahoma State.
A lot of ties between these two schools as coaches.
Let's see what Griffin Drew can come up with. He keeps the football here and runs it across the 25-yard line.
For the first time in Baylor history of the Big 12, they won three straight conference games. Never happened before. Two of them on the road. So they're riding a high so far today in the first half. Oklahoma State has had all the answers, and Baylor still got some questions to be answered.
Yeah, Baylor, most conference wins ever in their Big 12 history, coming in 4-1 here today. And first time they've been ranked in back-to-back weeks since 95. So a lot of firsts for this Baylor team. Now they need to make a huge comeback. Finley hangs on to this one as he gets the first down out near the 34. Tackled by Markel Martin.
You got an injured Baylor. Andrew McGee looks like he's hurt over there in front of the Baylor bench. He's down and hasn't gotten up.
The OSU corner out of McGee, Mississippi.
And he's leading the team with four interceptions, amongst the leaders in the Big 12 in the country even. I mean, he's been a big play guy for them, making plays on the perimeter.
Hopefully he is okay. Not a good position there. 4 minutes to go here in the half. We're going to take a brief break, and then we'll come back with more from Stillwater with the score 24-0 Cowboys. Andrew McGee showing, looks like he's going to be all right, and that's good news for OSU. Hey, coming up later, College Football Saturday continues. Eighth-ranked Oklahoma down at College Station to meet the Texas A&M Aggies, revitalized under Ryan Tannehill. Then the nightcap, it's ASU against USC in a Pac-10 battle at the Coliseum. Action continues, 7 Eastern, 6 Central, 4 Pacific. College Football Saturday. Here, it's been all Oklahoma State. Part of the problem is Baylor has had only one break in their starting field position from scrimmage as they hand off to Finley. Finley takes this out to the 38. Their drives have started at the 10, 20, 20, the 44, and they turned it over on downs, and then the 20, and again the 20. So they're going to have to create their break.
They got it at the 44 on fourth down when Oklahoma State went for it, and Blackmon dropped the touchdown pass, and they got the ball at the 44-yard line, and Oklahoma State's defense got it right back to their offense. Yeah, they've gone long field. The average drive start is well in the Cowboys' favor.
So second down here. Griffin tosses to right. Got the first down and dances before he steps out of bounds, but he's in Oklahoma State territory at the 47-yard line of the Cowboys.
Two things that Oklahoma State wanted to dictate and to win. Turnover battle and field position, and they're dominating both. Plus two, in their dominating field position.
Cowboys got 15 on that pickup. They come right back with the quick hitter out on the flat to Terrence Williams. He stopped by Thomas, who's made the last two tackles. And as soon as they set that down marker, they'll go again, where it is second down now and about four. And a little razzle-dazzle. Reese brings it back and has the first down to the 37-yard line. Tevin Reese stopped by Gent.
Yeah, Gent clotheslined him a little bit. Took him down rather unceremoniously. Nice little timing here, a little underneath pitch on the end around. And watch Gent. Whoop, a horse collar, came close. Grabbed him right by the back of the shoulder pads there, right underneath the helmet. But he didn't take him down in the first step and immediately bend him over backwards. But that's dangerous to get in that horse collar position. Baylor needs points right here to go into the locker room with some sort of momentum. Right now, down 24 points, they have no momentum.
You described that horse collar well. I'd appreciate if you wouldn't demonstrate on me. Thank you very much. It is second, first and 10, I should say, here at the 37. And the handoff, Finley breaks it, not Finley, but Ganaway breaks the tackle and steps up to the 26-yard line. Terrence Ganaway, junior from DeKalb, Texas. He's been averaging 6 yards a carry this season. Martin, the tackle.
5'11", 235-pounder. And boy, he splits a couple of tacklers and more of a short yardage goal line guy for him, but he can hammer it pretty well himself. Gets those shoulder pads squared up.
Nice burst on that one. First to 10 again. Griffin, pump fake. Got a man in the end zone.
Oh.
Intercepted, Oklahoma State, Johnny Thomas. The Cowboys get another turnover. Thomas, who had a pick for a touchdown last week, saves a touchdown this week.
Great recoverability. A little bit late on the throw is Robert Griffin. But boy, Johnny Thomas, his first career interception was last week. He takes it back for a touchdown against Kansas State. His second career interception in the end zone to prevent points by Baylor. And Johnny Thomas just reads the quarterback's eyes. He's the lurking safety, the center fielder. Robert Griffin, once he zeroed in on the pump fake, comes back to the middle of the football field. Johnny Thomas is reading his eyes and just works his way back and jumps and makes the play. He's trying to go to Burke.
Yeah, Chris Burke, who's suffered some injury stuff this year, was the intended receiver, so the Cowboys get it right back. 2:02, plenty of time to go to work, and they do. Bowling. That goes through his fingertips as Weeden has just been spectacular today.
He had to get rid of that one a little early because Jean-Baptiste was right on top of him. Weeden had to throw the football. He got taken to the turf after he released the football. A little bit inaccurate as a result of the inside pressure.
Weeden 17 of 21 for 208 and a score to Blackmon. And he had hit seven straight before that incompletion. And now they come back to Randall. A freshman running back out of Wichita takes it up to the 27-yard line, Johnson makes a stop.
Robert Griffin's interception a rarity. That's only his sixth on the season. He had 20 touchdowns to only 5 interceptions coming in. A 4-to-1 ratio. That's going to win you football games. That interception hurt him, though.
Cowboys trying to take advantage of it on a third down and going right ahead. Carried off to Jeremy Smith, who they told us they'd get more involved. He's made a couple of nice runs today. Here's what's coming up on the McDonald's halftime show. John Radigan, Gary Reasons, the crew in studio. Top 25 scores and highlights. Preview of that big one tonight from College Station, where number 8 Oklahoma meets Texas A&M. Remember, it's the Sooners that's part of this 3-team round robin for the South, along with Baylor and OSU, all with one loss coming into today. And Baylor and OSU both have Oklahoma left to play. Here's Blackmon again.
Nice little comeback route by Blackmon. He's already over 100 yards receiving, well over it now. I mean, it's not even halftime. That's his 8th catch for probably about a buck 15. He's strong, boy.
Making 111 officially on a 14-yard pickup there. And Randall is knocked at the 47 of Baylor. Clock at 52 seconds. Timeout now. Second timeout charge to Oklahoma State.
The first one was used to review the play. There was no reversal.
Art Briles and crew. Boy, it's talking about critical to try to hold them out here. As you take a look at our Sprint Now recap, it's been all pokes.
Well, and takeaways are a big part of it, and they did take it away. Broderick Brown stripping it out of there, ripping it out of there, and they capitalized with a touchdown pass to And then Bowling on the sideline, he makes Lander miss. Bowling doing a good job getting yards after catch. And then to get the ball down the field to the big boy once again, Blackmon, to set up the touchdown, and Hunter finishes it. So the triplets are getting very involved here. Blackmon runs a little bit of a post and finish it again with Kendall Hunter. So then this is right before, we just saw right Baylor trying to get points right before the half, denied, and denied very, very spectacularly by Johnny Thomas.
Now we're sitting with a second down for Weeden through, and he goes back to Bowling, and Bowling picks up the first down at the 37-yard line, and Hicks on the coverage. And as soon as they reset the chains, clock will move again. Remember, the Cowboys with one timeout remaining. 11 yards on that play. Sitting at the 37-yard line, 37 seconds to go. Comes over. Here's Kendall Hunter. And Hunter, the first down again, so that'll stop the clock for a moment. They'll hurry up to the line of scrimmage. He's at the 25-yard line. Chris Francis, the tackler, 11 yards on that play for Hunter.
Well, Baylor's getting tired. They had to call timeout. They tried to sub people, didn't get them off the field, didn't get them on the field. Baylor's been on the field for a lot of snaps defensively, and they are starting to just get into that Suez Canal water. I mean, they're heaving hard down there.
And what does that tell you? When they have to call a timeout with 23 seconds left, and Oklahoma State's only got one remaining.
Right.
But it's like, hey, if we don't, we're going to give up one right here.
Well, they didn't even have 4 men at the line of scrimmage. I mean, if Oklahoma State snapped that football, they would have gashed Baylor. Baylor only had about 8 or 9 guys out in the field that were even close to their alignment spots on the football field. And Art Browse is going to have to rally his team big time at the half.
Let's take a look at the reaction of Mike Gundy after the timeout called by Odom. You see Gundy back there.
He likes the fact that his team is up tempo, in condition,
controlling,
wearing down
it.
The Baylor Bears. They're in full control of this football game. That's a good way to put it.
Blackman's caught 8 for 115. Bowling 5 for 73 from Weeden, who goes to the air again here. And this one to Bowling, a super catch. And he got out of bounds as well at the 15-yard line.
How about the ability for Oklahoma State to make the contested catch? They always catch the football at the highest point, at the apex. And when it's in the air, they say it's mine.
10 yards on that play, first and 10 from the 15. Weeden going for 6 and nearly picked off that time. Intended in the end zone for Harrison. Stevenson was covering for Baylor.
Stevenson almost turned himself into a receiver, but watch Bowling here. Between two defenders, contested catch, he's hit early, and that contact doesn't disrupt his focus whatsoever. I mean, you're talking about a group of wideouts that want to make plays down the football field.
And it'll be a 31 yarder for Bailey. Remember, Bailey hit earlier today in the first possession, 23 yarder. And he misses his first miss of the season after Dan Bailey had connected on 17 of 17. And Baylor says, well, that's our highlight, unfortunately, as the Bears find themselves trailing 24-0 here at intermission. And 17th ranked Oklahoma State, that's about the only thing they've done wrong today, if you want to call that wrong.
Yeah, and Bailey can't believe it. He's befuddled because it wasn't a 50-yarder. I mean, it was a very makeable field goal at the gun, the last play of the half, and he just pushed it.
So the Cowboys with the lead, and Mike Gundy standing with our Emily Jones.
Thank you very much, Coach. You talked during the week about wanting to win the turnover battle. +3 so far. You've got to be pleased with your defense.
Well, our defense has done a nice job of forcing some turnovers, and then we've tackled fairly well up to this point. And offensively, we've moved with a good tempo, so I'm pleased with the way that we perform so far.
You also talked about special teams. Your field position's been pretty good and pinning them down deep.
Well, we've done a decent job on special teams. I wish we'd have made that last field goal, but our guys have moved around and we've made some plays.
All right, Coach, thanks for the time. We do appreciate it. Best of luck in the second half. It is 24-0 in favor of the Cowboys in Stillwater. We'll hit the break and then get you to Dallas for the halftime show with John Rattigan.
All right, and hey, we've all got one, right, Dave? I'm listening to those guys, and I'm going, boy, I know the game I'd like to have a do-over on.
I know the one I'd like to have, Super Bowl 16 up in Pontiac, Michigan against the 49ers.
Mine came wasn't up 5 points
short.
Level.
Yeah, came up 5 points short. Like to have that one over.
Speaking of do-overs, Baylor would like to have a first half do-over because it has been a nightmare. Now, our Academy Sports and Outdoors Right Stuff leaders, the big three, or triplets, if you will, of Oklahoma State, they have lived up to the billing.
Yeah, I mean, it's like Troy Aikman, you know, and it's like Michael Irvin, and it's like Emmitt Smith. Look at this, look at these triplets. I mean, big time numbers. They've been everything they've been billed to be. They've answered the bell today.
And Oklahoma State will get the football to start the second half. If you weren't with us, Bailey missed his first field goal attempt of the year to end the first half. And the kick comes to the Cowboys and to the 25 and to the 30-yard line, where it'll be first and 10 for OSU as we take a look at the OSU first half possessions.
Well, look at the number of plays. That's the impressive part. I mean, every time they had the football, they ran multiple plays and they scored quite a few times. Missed field goal, the shocking missed field goal at the conclusion of the half by Dan Bailey, his first miss of the season. I mean, he goes 8 plays, 80 yards, 12 plays, 75 yards. I mean, you're going on methodical, sustained drives.
Weeden, first and 10. Hands it off there to Blackmon, coming around. Blackmon needing a block. 45, stretching it. 40, still in bounds. 20, Blackmon, touchdown. Oh, mama, what a play.
Oh. Dana Holgerson comes up with a gadget gimmick play to start the half. And how about Bo Bowling down the football field making the block to finalize the play? Justin Blackmon get the ball in his hands, and it'll be very, very nice for you. Look at Baylor. They all bite on the play, on the fake, and Blackmon comes around blocking on the perimeter. And watch Bowling hustle down the football field here. And pick up the block. Look at him. Stay after it. Make sure he gets into the end zone. The personal escort. Tremendous.
69 yards. And Justin Blackmon normally doing it, catching the pass. Just caught a little flip there. That'd be a run. And Bailey knocks the extra point through. And oh my goodness. 21 seconds into the half. 31-0. And waving the flags here in Stillwater today. Blackmon with a 69-yard run matches Kendall Hunter's first half rushing output on one play, and the Cowboys just stunned Baylor. And here's the kickoff. Baker will let it go and they'll bring it back out. Here's sixth game for Blackmon with two or more touchdowns.
Well, fake to Hunter and then rise up like you're gonna throw it, fake the throw, and then run the reverse. And Baylor bites on the fake throw. Now you get blocking on the perimeter. Excellent job on the edge. Tremendous job by Isaiah Anderson. He breaks a tackle down the field. And then once again, Bo Bowling finishes it. That's just outstanding. When you have a long run, usually on the edge, you have people that are going above and beyond and sustaining blocks. Nice effort in terms of design and execution by Oklahoma State.
So Griffin and company try to go back to work here and just get something positive going. But what a deflator to come out of the locker room and the Cowboys take the first play. Here's what Baylor's done on their possession so far in the first half. Jones made the tackle on that play.
The one drive you really get going, you end up fumbling the football. I mean, you're moving the ball and then another drive, interception.
Now Griffin, he is stopped. And it'll be a third down and long coming up for the Bears. On their first possession here, Jones again leading the way for the Cowboy defense.
How about Daniel Holgerson, though, coming out of the locker room with the call? Okay, let's run a misdirection because you know that Brian Norwood chewed out his defense. Run to the ball, play physically, so let's use that against them. They're going to be after it. Let's use that strength of theirs against them, make it a weakness, and that was just a great call.
Griffin. And he got hammered just as he was about to deliver the football and still down.
Yep.
Robert Griffin Jones again made the first two tackles and then applied the pressure here.
Well, it's no secret when the score is 31-0, The offensive and defensive lines are being handled by Oklahoma State. They are owning the pits, and he got lit up from the backside, blindside. Never saw it happen, never saw it coming, and that's when you can get hurt. And looks like he got off the field under his own power, obviously shaken up, but I think he's going to remain in the football game.
So Epperson, who averaged 45 yards a kick on his three punts in the first half, will kick it away, and Josh Cooper is the deep man. Cooper fields at the 29. Made one miss before he is stood up, and Cowboys will get good field position though at the 33-yard line. 49-yard kick, 4-yard return. Justin Blackmon, he's done it again today after the one-game suspension.
Now he can do it all. I mean, he runs great routes. He's in condition. He makes contested catches. I mean, any ball that's in the air, he feels like it is his. He's got very soft hands, very aware where he is on the football field at all times. Get the ball in his hands. However you get in his hands, he's going to produce for you. Justin Blackmon, one by air, one on the ground, two touchdowns, and he also dropped another touchdown. I mean, his numbers would be 9 catches, 160 yards, and 2 touchdowns if he doesn't drop it.
Weeden throwing here, and incomplete.
And I'd like to give some props to the offensive line for Oklahoma State and for the offensive line coach, Joe Wickline. Joe Wickline has this offensive line playing at an exceptionally high level. They are the epitome of an offensive line. You're only as good as the guy next to you. And these guys are playing super football.
Yeah, he'll tell you, or Dana Holgorsen is telling us, that there's not a star among them. There's not a guy going, oh, there's your first round draft pick. It's not like some of the past that they've had here around here.
Yeah.
But he said as a group, they just fit. They just get it.
Well, it's like the New York Giants for years. They didn't have any Pro Bowlers, but as a group, everybody, the sum total of the parts was better than any individual athlete. And that's the best compliment you can give an offensive line.
Weeden, third down, complete to Blackmon. Got the first down, trying to get more, and is finally wrestled to the ground by Clifton Odom. And it will move the chains, though, out to the 48-yard line of OSU, a pickup of 13.
I mean, he's like Zimbada, whatever that thoroughbred's name is. This guy never tires out. I mean, Blackmon is just, he's a cut above in terms of athletic ability. 6'1", 205, can run all day.
Headed for another double-digit receiving afternoon as Kendall Hunter stopped near the line of scrimmage on a first down carry. Let's send it down to Emily Jones.
Well, guys, you were talking about this Oklahoma State offense, and Dana Holgorsen can't sing enough praises about Brandon Weeden, his quarterback, the 27-year-old. He says shows such maturity, handles himself in such a professional way. Obviously, the baseball background comes into play in that regard, but he really is so impressed with how quickly he's picked up on this offensive scheme.
Yeah, well, everything rolls off his back. Any criticism Dana Holgorsen gives him rolls off his back.
Yep, maturity adds up. Watch out, Randall going to the races, and he finally is knocked down at the 30, make it the 28-yard line. Antonio Johnson tugging on Joseph Randall.
You know, Weeden doesn't get flustered. He's been in pressure situations, and he's going to give the ball right now to a guy that can really scoop, Joseph Randall. I mean, he is a big play waiting to happen as well. 193-pound freshman. I mean, there's talent in the funnel here now.
24 yards on that play. Bowling from Weeden. And he'll pick up 5 or 6. Well, Mike Gundy said his quarterback has really come along this year.
He's gotten much better in the last month. In the last couple weeks, he's really done a good job of handling the scheme. Coach Holgorsen will tell you that he's improved in that area. He's got a long ways to go in this system, which I'm learning just like he is. So I don't really have a good barometer for how far he should be in this system. I listen to what he has to say about Brandon, and he's improved, but his demeanor and his composure and his competitiveness is really what's helped him.
And once again, he completes the pass on a 2nd and 3 at the 22, zips a first down pass down to the 11-yard line, picks up 11 on that pass play, and they're knocking on the door again, up 31 zip.
And look how the receivers come back to the football. I mean, they compete every single time the ball's in the air.
We will play action here. Rolling out, still looking, and not much you can do there. Blackmon just scoots out of bounds, and they throw it away.
You know, Weeden is, this guy has been on the mound, with the bases loaded, a 3-2 count in a tie football game, that's pressure. I mean, this guy's, you can't fluster him. And he's unrattleable in that regard. He's 27 years old. He's been through the gauntlet of pressure as a minor league baseball pitcher. Right now, he's just having some fun.
Second and 10, and to Bowling. Couldn't quite get it. Bowling looking for his first touchdown. He had a big week last weekend when he had 8 catches on the day. McCall makes the tackle here, but he didn't get in the end zone. Had 6 first half catches this afternoon. Bowling.
Well, Baker's in trouble. He got up slowly after that completion. Now all he has to do is guard Blackmon. Hopefully they're going to double him and give him some help. But Baker is hurting. He got hurt on that last play, and he's struggling right now at the line of scrimmage.
Again, Weeden rolling out. Zips it into the end zone. Nearly picked off.
Should have been.
Trying to go to Harrison. Brian was the defender, and Baker there as well.
Well, Dana Holgerson's not going to like that throw because Weeden is rolling to his left and throws back across his body late to the middle of the football field, and this is what can happen. I mean, you know, guys will read that, break on the football, undercut it. It should have been picked off.
So it gives Bailey another chance on the field goal after his first miss of the season to end the first half, and they'll set up at the 13 for a 23-yard field goal attempt. This one is up and is good. So the Cowboys like the way they started the first half with 10 on their first two possessions. They do the same here, 34-0.
Welcome back to Stillwater, Oklahoma. The Cowboys in control in this one, and they appreciate special teams around here. You guys have got a Heisman campaign going for not Justin Blackmon, but who?
We're going for Dan Bailey.
Dan Bailey. And why would you select Dan Bailey for Heisman?
Well, because he is 7 points away from the number one all-time leading scorer at OSU.
Yeah.
Look at that. He paints well and he knows his stuff. Don't forget, football fans, you can cast your vote today for the McDonald's Ultimate Fan of the Season. The winner receives $10,000 towards a fan cave and other great prizes. Log on to www.fanoftheseason.com and vote now. And if you want to vote Dan Bailey for Heisman, you can vote that too.
Who wouldn't want the fan cave? Thank you, Emily. Ball taken back by Baylor from the 10 and out to the goal, I should say, to the 25-yard line before brought down. And Baker on the return, and Jones, a bigger pardon, and flag is thrown on the play as well.
Yeah, they're going to have an illegal block again back inside the 20. And Quinn Sharp has kicked off well. Quinn Sharp has a great, but he hasn't punted yet.
During the return, holding return team number 17. 10-yard penalty. First down.
You know, Quinn Sharp has not had to punt. He hasn't had the letter as a punter in this football game, and the takedown block is executed out there by Mike Hicks, and that's going to cost Baylor some field position. And how many times have they been at the 20 or inside the 20-yard line? One of the keys for Oklahoma State was field position and turnovers, and they have executed big time in those two keys.
Yeah, I mean, Baylor's had two opportunities to return a kick. They finally bring one out, and then they have the penalty. So on a brilliant sunny day, it has rained on Baylor most of the afternoon. As Griffin comes out throwing here to right and complete around the 18-yard line. Gent and Thomas making the tackle for Oklahoma State.
How about Bill Young and the Oklahoma State defensive football team, though? Baylor coming in 10th in the country passing, 8th in total offense, and they're shut out right now. That's a shock.
Baylor, this is 7 times on 8 possessions that they've started the 20 or inside.
Head ball, false start, offense, number 59, 5-yard penalty.
Well, that gentleman's responsibility to throw the flag is to the line judge is to watch the left tackle and watch for holding. And at that point, it doesn't get to that phase of it because Danny Watkins flinched before the snap of the football and cost his team 5.
Handoff for the Bears as they run it. Jarka makes the tackle. 9:09 to go third quarter, and Finley on the carry that time. Baylor, talk about how they've been ravaged by the OSU offense. Oklahoma State has 499 yards of offense on 58 plays.
Amazing.
Granted, you get a 69-yarder to open the half, but it was already, I mean, first half they had 369.
Yep, they're averaging over 45 a game and over 527 yards. I mean, they're going to blow those away today.
Griffin, good protection here, and he drills a nice pass across to Terrence Williams. And Williams is stopped at the 34-yard line. Johnny Thomas there.
And RG3 is probably in shock. You know, after TCU beat Baylor up, great throw right there, accurate with some velocity on it. He said, I'm allergic to losing. We can't lose games like this anymore at Baylor. We're too good. Well, it happens, happened again in Stillwater.
And this time they run it again as carrying it out to the 43-yard line. Finley. At Griffin, 23 plays of 30 yards or more on the season, but yep. None today.
Yep.
I mean, the big play has been a big part of Baylor's success. They've had games, the Texas game was kind of like it, to where they go along and they're not doing much, making a few here and there, and then a big play, boom, and next thing you know, they get on the board.
They haven't
gotten that today.
Three plays, Bill, for touchdowns last week for 150 yards and 158 yards and three touchdowns. The other 65 plays, 160 yards.
Right up the middle this time, and finally a big hole. And carrying the football was Jared Salubi, the sophomore from Waco, Texas.
Everybody's getting a chance here, and Salubi's kind of like the compromise between Finley and Ganaway. He's bigger than Finley, smaller than Ganaway, has his own skill set, and he looked pretty good with that skill set on that carry.
Yeah, limited rushes this year, 15 for 104 coming in. Great pickup there. And now Griffin goes back to the air, connecting with Terrence Williams. Shy of the first down, McGee makes the tackle, and it's at the 26-yard line of Oklahoma State, as Baylor right now just concentrating on trying to avoid being shut out. First and 10 line is brought to you by Phillips Television. Again, Salubi, very elusive, and shows a little power as he pushes the pile at the 15-yard line.
Oh, it's time to salute Salubi a little bit right here, because this kid, he's hungry. I mean, his team is down 34-0. You'd never know it by the effort that he's given. I mean, this kid is starving for opportunity and carries, and every chance he's given, he is trying to make the most of it.
So first and 10 now for Baylor at the 16. And again, to the running game. That opens up a nice hole as Gent makes the tackle. Finley the carrier.
You look at the Oklahoma State defense, they gave up 14 points in Kansas State last week, none in two quarters. So the last six quarters, they've only allowed 14 points, although Baylor knocking on the doorstep right here. Will they finish?
Griffin. Second down and right up the middle, and touchdown Baylor. Just like that, as Finley, after Baylor struggling all afternoon, they take that drive, it looked like they have it so many other times this season.
And just good blocking up front. I mean, they get after it. Everybody, I mean, the Red Sea parted. The little block back by the center. The Red Sea parts, and Finley scores his sixth rushing touchdown in the last 3.5 games.
And the point after is good by Aaron Jones. And Baylor on the board. Jay Finley with the TD. Check your local listings.
I hope our good friend Adrian Peterson helps square away the Vikings. That's a mess up there.
Boy, no kidding. Got a feeling they rely heavily on him to kick off to Oklahoma State, and the Cowboys bring it back to about the 24-yard line. Johnny Thomas. And the Pokes with their first push here will go to 500 yards. They're at 499. Weeden, by the way, currently 2,828 yards passing on the season. It's now the third highest single season total. He passed Zach Robinson. And remember, for OSU, this is game number 9. So a lot more to come for Brandon Weeden, having just a terrific season. Passes it out here with blockers. And Randall rolls to the 38-yard line of the OSU side before Hicks makes a tackle.
You know, you're talking about numbers, Bill. Oklahoma State could be the first team in college football history. Brandon Weeden throwing right here, the screen pass. If he throws for 3,500 yards, and if Hunter rushes for 1,500, Blackmon catches, passes for 1,500, that's never happened before in college football history.
Amazing. Going for a punch here.
And it is caught at the 20, the 10. Touchdown, Oklahoma State.
Tyler Stevenson, Mike Hicks, lack of communication. I mean, this is nothing fancy whatsoever. I mean, you know, somebody has to communicate out there in terms of coverage.
62 yards.
And just let him split the corner in safety. Nobody has deep coverage. Unbelievable. I mean, that's at this stage of the game, that's inexcusable, really.
Colton Shelf with the touchdown reception, and now the PAT as Oklahoma State. Big plays, I guess. Shelf with the TD reception from Brandon Weeden, and Oklahoma State seven more.
Well, they passed the 500. They're gaining on 600 awfully quickly.
Yeah.
I mean, how many are they going to get today?
Well, check with Tulsa. They had 722 against the Golden Hurricane earlier this year. And this is a Cowboy team that has run up some incredible offensive totals. Well, we had the game, of course, the season opening when they had 65 points against Washington State. Mm. Gave us an idea of what was to come. And speaking of Shelf, let's send it down to Emily Jones with more.
Well, guys, Dana Holgorsen talked about how consistent that Colton Shelf has been. He hasn't gotten a whole lot of receptions, just 6 for 86 yards coming into this game. However, he said he acts a lot tougher than he is, which is very important when you're 5'9", 165 pounds. Didn't have to show a whole lot of toughness in that play, but definitely some speed and good instincts as far as catching the ball and taking it to the end zone.
I'll tell you, these inside receivers, Oklahoma State, you know, Shelf is a Wes Welker type guy. You know, I mean, that body type, and there's quite a few of those. And the inside receivers of the ilk of Shelf and others are the heart and soul of this passing game.
And the kickoff goes to the 5, and bring it out across the 25-yard line was Odom, a 20-yard return, or Jones again, beg your pardon, Darius Jones, the redshirt freshman.
You know, I bet at this point the Baylor sideline is in shock. I mean, Art Briles has to be pretty much in shock. I mean, I bet he felt that this program, this football team was beyond this. You know, this was a, you know, they've had good memories on the road their last two conference games.
Yeah.
Real good memories, and come from behind memories. This is a nightmare memory they're going to have to block out of their minds.
First and 10. And for Baylor, particularly disturbing after they finally score, and then bang, just another quick touchdown for Oklahoma State. Lewis makes the tackle on Finley this time.
And you know, you can understand physical mistakes, you're gonna get beaten physically, but mental errors, they kill you. The mental errors just absolutely eat you up.
Griffin throws it out in the flat and complete across the 40-yard line. Williams, the receiver, Gent, the tackler.
When you're getting pre-snap penalties, false starts in the red zone, this sets you back. You know, and assignment errors in coverage, this sets you back. Turnovers, I mean, they're making mistakes physically, mentally, every way they can make mistakes, they're making them today, and you can't do it against a good team on the road.
First and 10 here. Play action, Griffin.
Ooh.
Oh, thought it was going for right. Zip right over him, but yeah, it was complete to the other receiver behind him, and that was Williams again.
Just like he drew it up. I mean, this is exactly how you practice it.
Yeah, if
this,
you don't know who you're throwing it to, how can the defense?
Yeah, it's a ricochet route. Ricochet and make the play. That's just unbelievable.
Right, so give me an assist, would you? I'm coming back against the grain, and a big hit put on Kendall Wright as Lewis makes the tackle here.
You know, everybody practices the tip drill, defensive backs, wide receivers, and the tip drill is executed right there on the old deflection.
4:30 and counting, third quarter here. 41-2 for Oklahoma State to 7 for Baylor. And timeout for a measurement. Chain gang's even tired, the way they've had to move up and down the field. They got tangled up earlier on that Baylor sideline with OSU, the way they've moved in and trying to run that hurry up. And you see what the difference is. It's going to be very short. Art Briles still fighting for his team.
I'll tell you, the military, that they're doing the push-ups, All those guys came in with 42-inch chests, and by the time this is over, they're going to have 48-inch chests. I mean, they're going to be doing push-ups. These guys are, look at them. They're already posing. Yeah, the beach is that way. I mean, they've already been doing push-ups galore, and they got a few more probably left. One thing, and I want to thank all those guys and every one of their contemporaries for doing what they do to make this country as great as it is and give us an opportunity to have fun in Stillwater today. It's because of those young men and everybody else in the armed forces that give us the opportunity.
Certainly echo those comments. Third and one after the measurement. And he made it, so it'll be maintaining possession for Baylor. First and 10 for the Bears.
And that's the thing, Oklahoma State did everything they wanted, Bill. They played keep away, then they made the big play, the offensive dynamo.
Finley trying to make one miss, not much doing as Thomas out there helping string that play along and making the tackle for Oklahoma State.
Thomas is gaining confidence every single game. This guy has star quality written all over him. Defensive player of the game for the Cowboys last week against Kansas State.
Cowboys have had 60 plays for 575 yards. Baylor 57 plays for 296 yards. Baylor coming in second in the league, 490 yards per game. They moved the ball some. They just, within that last drive, limited big plays. And this one incomplete. He's trying to draw one up for Kendall Wright on that possession.
And again, you know, they ran into Bill Young on the road. And Bill Young, the defensive coordinator for Oklahoma State, has seen it all and seen it all more than once. This guy's forgotten more football than most of us have ever known. And he doesn't get flustered. I mean, nothing, you know, makes Bill Young lose his composure. And he has an answer for everything. And he's mixed up his pressures and coverages well today.
Coach at all three schools D1 in this state, Tulsa and Oklahoma. Is it Miami, Kansas, Ohio State, Arizona State, a little bit in the NFL as well. You mentioned he's seen it all. And one of the things he does so well is he just prepares his team. It keeps it as simple as possible.
Yeah, he does. He does. And players respond to him. It's easy to buy what Bill Young is selling because, you know, not only a great football coach, but his delivery and the way he comports himself, he is a quality human being.
Cooper returns for the punt situation here for Oklahoma State as Epperson stands at his own 40. Boots it away on a fourth down and 9.
Wow.
And he deadened it, and Baylor will down it. Did they not? I guess they could hold on.
They didn't control it.
They
didn't control it.
Yeah.
That's kind of a microcosm of what's taking place for Baylor today, isn't it?
Terrific punt. It comes back a little bit, and about four guys couldn't down the football. And it's going to come out to the 20-yard line now. And I want to remind you that FoxSportsSouthwest.com, the place to go if you want to stay up on whatever it is in the Big 12. Football, you got videos, you got replays of stuff. Your favorite Big 12 schools, check it out. FoxSportsSouthwest.com, the place for Big 12 football.
It was crazy. Jared Monk went down to cover it, and as he tried to fall over on top of the football, he slung it into the end zone, never had possession. All he has to do is touch it and down it. He dives for it, and as he's rolling, as he's trying to recover it, he hurls it into the end zone. Nuts.
So Weeden will come back on. Randall goes in motion, and here come the Cowboys again. Watch out. Blackmon got a block. And breaks it to the 30. That wasn't far away from being another 50-plus play. 12 yards on the pickup for Justin Blackmon.
And he makes you hold your breath every time the ball is airborne to him. And again, look at, he's playing at another tempo. I mean, he does not tire out. He is at full speed at all times. You have to be on your toes defending that cat.
Blackman's 10th catch today, 140 yards. Kendall Hunter. Is wrapped up and brought for a loss. Fumble the football.
Ball.
Baylor's picked it up and going on and nearly scoring on the play. Was that Lander?
Yes.
Yep. Byron Lander takes it down to nearly the 2-yard line.
Look at that football player. He's hurt. Look at the left shoulder. I mean, the shoulder pads exposed out of the jersey, and just the ball stripped out. Again, once again, both defenses doing a good job of tackling the football. Tevin Elliott that time rips the football out, and Hunter falls on Elliott's body, so he's not down before the football comes out. And Lander says, thanks, we'll try to take this to the house. Elliott and Lander combined, forced fumble, fumble recovery.
So Baylor hanging in there, still giving great effort. And
they're gonna take another look at this. The officials coming all the way down to take another look to make sure that indeed it is truly a fumble and that the recovery took place and it was advanced.
There'll be a review on this one. And I don't think they're going to overturn this one.
Yeah, I think this one's pretty clear cut. Good little run there, though.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed.
You know what he's thinking?
Good cardio.
How
good
about
cardio.
A thumbs up?
Yeah, right. Yeah.
You know,
Justin Blackmon, this is his drill every day at Oklahoma State. A little bit more rapid pace, though, but.
Oh, I tell you what, said, you got to be kidding me.
That was some good cardio there. And, you know, it's in the second half. It's not the first quarter of the game. It's nice endurance by the officiating crew.
So Baylor will have it first and goal at the 2-yard line. Finley will line up here behind quarterback as Griffin. Give it to him. Second effort, spins into the end zone. Touchdown, Baylor. Jay Finley gets his second TD in Baylor's of the day and of this quarter. And gone from 24-0 at the half to 41 now to 13.
In the last three games and three quarters of a fourth, Finley has 7 rushing touchdowns. He's picked up 2 today. He came in with 5 touchdowns in his last three games. And again, when Finley gets those shoulder pads squared up, El Lodo.
And the point after is good once again by Jones. And there's Finley's numbers today as Oklahoma State still leads. But it is 41-14 now here in Stillwater with 2:24 remaining in the third quarter of this Big 12 battle for first place.
I'll tell you, it looks like a lot of the Baylor Bears, Finley on one of his touchdown runs get up slowly. A lot of Baylor Bears are nicked up. And you know, those bumps and bruises hurt a lot more when you're down 27. When you're up 27, those bumps and bruises aren't even an issue.
Yeah.
But it's tougher to play through them when you're looking at the scoreboard and you got to climb Mount Everest.
So with 2:24 to go, Baylor's thinking, well, if we're going to have, remember the miracle in the Brazos down in Waco many, many years ago? Well, if you're going to have the miracle in Stillwater, you got to get some stops, and more importantly, you got to get some turnovers like they just did and get an easy score or two if you're going to have any opportunity to fight your way back into it.
But yeah, and it would be, the headline would be Stillwater Stunner. Baylor comes from, you know, over 30 points down, but you know, that there's not nobody on that Baylor sideline, Art Briles in particular, nobody's going to spit the bit.
No.
They're going to fight and paddle and scratch and claw to the last snap.
Allow that to happen.
No way.
This team would have achieved what they've got if they had that kind of attitude.
Yep.
There's a kickoff to Thomas, and he brings it to the 35 and is stopped. The 25, I should say. Johnny Thomas, as Earl Patton makes the tackle there.
I've heard you call Johnny Thomas 4 times on kick coverage. This kid is a starting safety who had his second interception of his career, and he's covering kickoffs like a demon. Johnny Thomas is a football player, bar nothing else.
He was certainly special, not only today, last week up at Kansas State, big part of their defensive effort up there, and had the touchdown return on the INT, down the ball on the 1-yard line on the one punt.
He was huge on specials last week as well, as he's been all year long, and now he's making plays at the line of scrimmage defensively.
It's Oklahoma State trying to stay sharp as they will head to Austin next week to meet Texas. This one a completion to Randall and tripped up at the 29-yard line. Odom making the tackle there. And Baylor will meet Texas A&M in Waco next Saturday night. And the thing to remember is regardless, if Baylor ends up losing this game, you're still not out of it in the South.
Yep.
Bowling pushes forward about the 34, because the final part of this season has come down to Oklahoma State, Baylor, and Oklahoma all playing a round robin with one another and all having one loss prior to today. And you could just take a look at the schedule and see who's playing who and find out that, yeah, it's going to be much more difficult if you drop this game, but
sure,
certainly not impossible to still get a share of the South Championship and end up going to the title game. Randall tackled for a loss. Lander comes through with that play for Baylor.
I love that kid. You know, he got hurt pretty badly. For him to leave the field the way he did in the first half and just suck it up and get out there and continue, this game is important to him, the game of football. And he plays it hard. You know, he was mentored by Lake, who played safety, it seemed like, for two decades at Baylor. And those guys talk a lot of football, and he is carrying that torch. He is a hard-hitting safety.
Quinn Sharp for his first punt of the day. Tells you how the Cowboys have dominated. He's first in the Big 12, fifth nationally at 47 yards a kick.
Oof.
And Burke is the deep man. He goes all the way back inside his 15 and brings it across the 25 near the 28-yard line.
Turn that one over.
Yeah, Quinn Sharp, who last week hit four punts. The only reason his average dropped, he was leading the nation, was he hit four inside the 10 last week, three inside the five. This was a 59-yarder with a 15-yard return.
Yeah, he's remarkable.
Dana Holgerson.
He's not happy. He's not happy. He's never satisfied. That's a ball coach right there.
So you better not let up, fellas. So
I'll tell you, Bedlam is going to be wild against Oklahoma here.
Griffin's pass across the middle right, a little short. Couldn't hang on. Levy covering.
You know, you wonder how many more possessions will Baylor be afforded. The third quarter is melting away. The clock is definitely their enemy and Oklahoma State's ally.
This one deflected as it goes off the receiver's hands, and OSU diving for an interception attempt. Couldn't come up with it. I think Martin was the one closest to it.
Yeah, he tried to get the ball to Brad Taylor, it looked like, and just kind of ricocheted off of him.
Roderick Brown in the coverage area. Third down and 10 now, and an OSU player slow to get up, so they come out to help him off.
That's Moala.
Yeah. Moala, the senior from Inglewood, California, helped off the field here. Tolu Moala. Third and 10 now. The OSU fans wanting to stop here. Not allow Baylor to get any momentum going into that fourth quarter. Reese comes back to catch the football. He's shy of the first down, and a flag is thrown. Late flag.
And I think they're going to get Johnny Thomas for a shot on Kendall Wright late. Maybe a personal foul on Johnny Thomas potentially. Bill Young, though, rushed three and dropped eight on third and long. Kept him short of the chains, but talking over the penalty right now. Bill Young tried to put eight back there in coverage and give minimal windows for RG3 to take advantage of.
Griffin last week.
There is no foul for face mask. Shirt collar was grabbed.
Okay.
We'll clear it up.
Well, fourth down. Is it four down territory everywhere? If you're Art Briles, it's fourth and short. Do you go for it or do you punt it away? Yeah, I didn't see any face mask there. I thought down the football field there was a little something going on between Kendall Wright and Johnny Thomas. I thought that might have been a something that they were policing.
End of the quarter here, and Baylor will make a decision as to whether or not they want to go for it when we come back for the fourth quarter. So good news for the Bears, they get on the board a couple of times. Bad news, they have had no answer to the Oklahoma State powerhouse offense. And after three quarters, it is 41-14 Oklahoma State. You're watching Big 12 College Football Saturday, presented by Academy Sports and Outdoors. ING Direct Timeout Wow, Brandon Weeden, 374 yards, two TDs, no picks. Blackmon 10 for 140, also ran one for 69 and a touch. And total yards, 586 to 305. We got a quarter to go.
Yeah, this is amazing. The calculators and scoreboards are going to start burning. I mean, there's going to be short circuits out there.
And that last line, the most important to Baylor. Those three turnovers set the tone in this first half.
Yep.
Here's Cooper. 5:30, got a block, flag thrown. 50, breaks another one down to the 30. But a flag thrown back on the 29-yard line of Oklahoma State. And a nullified Josh Cooper's fine return.
I think James Thomas got one on Antonio Johnson, coverage by the Baylor linebacker that was an illegal block in the back. I don't know if that's the one they saw and called, but you know, you look at Oklahoma State, Blackmon, 10 catches, 140 yards. Bowling supports him with 9 for 101. Those two
during
receivers.
The return of the kick, illegal block in the back on the return team, number 80. 10-yard penalty, first down.
They call Cooper Bassett.
Nullifies a 51-yard return after the 45-yard punt by Epperson to start the fourth quarter.
That must be it right there.
Boy, and Cooper made a nice hurdle there to set things up.
Ooh, a couple of questionables in the back. How about two receivers, though? 19 catches for 241 yards. Blackmon 10 for 140, Bowling 9 for 101.
Well, and here's Weeden with 374 yards passing. The OSU most yards for passing single game is 430 by Zach Robinson. So he certainly will have the chance to break that today, whether or not he'll go the distance or whatever happened. But he comes out firing here and connects with Blackmon for Blackman's 11th reception of the day. And Brian makes the tackle on.
Well, Weeden already this year, 409 against Tulsa, fourth most in school history, 356 against Texas Tech, eighth most, 351 against Louisiana, 10th most, 348 against Troy, 11th most. He's on the boards again.
Randall falls forward to the 35, got the first down easily on the second and short. Tackle made by Atchison.
Now, the thing about Weeden, he's got two things that are going to help any quarterback: arm strength equaling velocity and pinpoint accuracy. I mean, he puts the ball on point almost every time.
First and 10 here from the 35. Blackmon, great timing, throw it, and got the reception as Weeden found him, made another miss, and Blackmon scampers out of bounds near midfield.
Man,
what a talent.
He's amazing. The patience on this one. I mean, watch the patience. Sit, wait. And then watch this peel back. Oh my goodness. That's picking them off. That's peeling them off there. Josh Cooper lit up McCall at the linebacker level.
Blackman's 12th reception for 161. And this time Randall with it across midfield to the 48-yard line. Blackmon, 12 for 164 today.
Tell you, when you see wide receivers throw depleter blocks, that's impressive.
Yeah, and wide receivers who've been catching the ball too. So
yeah.
Weeden took advantage of Bowling, just run a little interference out there, and Weeden takes it. See where they step out at the 44-yard line. It'll be third down and short. You know, Blackmon came in averaging 159 per game. That was number one in the NCAA. He's already past that, so he's going to bump that average a little bit here today, too.
And if he doesn't drop the touchdown, that's another catch, 12 catches, and that's another 45 yards. I mean, he could have had, he's pushing 200 yards today if he catches everything.
Easily. Weeden scrambling here. Going to keep it and does the smart thing. As three Bears were converging, did he get the first down? I don't think so. He had to get to the 40. He's a little mad at himself, but he started that slide a little too soon.
Yeah, assume the fetal position. And he's a former baseball player. He's done this before. He slid into a base a time or two, and he just had a football in his hands this time.
And they will go for it on a fourth down and one.
I was hoping to see the hook slide or the pop-up slide or something like that.
He was hoping to see the first downside. Flea flicker.
Wow.
Weeden going here for Blackmon. Incomplete. Flag throw.
Yep, calling interference. Boy, fourth down for the second time, they go deep to Blackmon. Fourth down the other time was the 45-yard touchdown pass that he couldn't control. This time, interference obvious. The contact is well before the arrival of the football. Brian will be penalized. It'll cost Baylor 15 yards.
There were fouls by both teams. Holding, offense number 7. Defensive pass interference, number 8. Those penalties will offset. Replay fourth down.
Oh, okay, so.
Holding number 7 offense. Michael Harrison.
Yeah. So that nullifies what would have been the
what
first
the
down.
How is he holding? Trying to think, was he in blitz pickup as a wideout?
Didn't see that flag.
Yeah, so that's an interesting one.
Oh, all the attention was downfield. And so they'll go for it again here on this 4th and 1.
And will they be more conventional and just try to hammer it up inside and move the chains?
I'm going to throw it. Weeden delivers. What a strike. Oh, my, the Blackmon. Makes those throws look so easy. Absolute bullet. Ryan tackles Blackmon, but Blackmon continues to rack up the yardage as well.
Nothing fancy. And you know, get the one-on-one coverage on the outside, and Blackmon runs his route. And I'll tell you what, Dana Holgorsen was a little curious with the chemistry and timing between Weeden and Blackmon. Would it be intact or would it suffer a little bit with the suspension last week against Kansas State? Not a timing, rhythm, chemistry. It's all there. Check, check, check.
Weed now at 407 yards on 32 of 40. Hands this one off to Randall. Randall, 30, 25, sprinting down the sideline. Knocked out of play at the 20-yard line. Time there for the Baylor Bears.
Boy, Jeremy Smith, nice block on the outside. Excellent effort. Watch number 31 in the orange jersey on the outside. I'm not sure if we're going to kill it right there. See that cut block? Excellent. They're all still working hard.
Randall 13 yards, 66 yards on the day. This one to Cooper. Cooper to the 5. Cooper dives in. Touchdown, Cowboys. Josh Cooper. His third TD of the season on the receiving end.
And again, Blackmon is dynamic on the outside. But the blue-collar inside receivers are big time in this football team. And here's Cooper, a good example of it. Make you miss, finish, break tackles, touchdown, big time.
Josh Cooper, the junior from Mustang, Oklahoma. And here is Bailey for the PAT. And this one is good. And Oklahoma State now 48 to 14 on Cooper's TD reception from Weeden. Well, Dave gave a nice salute to our friends in the military earlier as they continue to do the push-ups here. And we'd also like to pile on, if you will. Today's broadcast is on the American Forces Network, the AFN, as it is known, to the U.S. Armed Forces serving 175 countries and aboard ships at sea. Glad to have you with us, watching around the world in Iraq, Germany, Italy, Southwest Asia, South Korea, and Japan. Welcome, and again, we cannot thank you enough for your service.
Yep, and God bless each and every one of you.
Here's the way to stop Black Massage.
Yeah.
It's about it. And the kickoff to the goal line to the 1. Jones again, and he is brought shy of the 20 and stopped there, and that's where Baylor will get possession. 18-yard return for Darius Jones, and it's 1st and 10 for the Bears with 10:57 remaining.
Well, as you look again at Oklahoma State, what they wanted, the objectives, win the turnover battle, take it away. They got 3 today. Now they have 25 takeaways in the season. They want to score touchdowns, not settle for field goals. Check. And they wanted to win the hidden yards. Check. I mean, they are just absolutely executing everything they needed to execute. That's a happy head coach right there, Mike Gundy.
Rutgers offensive coordinator Dana Holgorsen as Griffin comes out in here and complete to Sampson. It's his, I think it's his first reception of the day. He'll send it back down to Emily Jones.
Well, guys, safe to say that Robert Griffin will be very disappointed with his team's effort today. Maybe not necessarily the effort, but definitely the outcome. He was very vocal about his disappointment when they played so poorly against TCU, and he's made the quote, "We are as I am." He's perfectly aware that this team will go as he goes, so you can bet there will be some adjustments made in between now and the A&M game.
Yeah, and Emily, I wonder if there's another player that is more important to his community, you know, his campus, his team, than Robert. I mean, RG3 is what it's all about. And they've upgraded the level of athlete they can get at Baylor once they sign this guy.
Yeah, and as they keep it on the ground here, as Finley rolls across the 45. You know, the loss to TCU was 45-10. At
right.
the time, that was a shocker because they won their first two games convincingly. Granted, the competition wasn't great. Sam Houston stayed in Buffalo, but it kind of put them back on, all right, that ain't going to happen again. Well, then they roll, and the only other game they've lost since then was the 7-point game, 45-38 to Tech. No shame in that, but they very easily had an opportunity there.
Yep.
So this is kind of that next stage of, wow, what happened? You know, coming in here thinking we're at that level again.
They were an eyelash. Kendall Wright had a catchable pass to the back of the end zone, tying that Texas Tech game up and taking it over.
Griffin, plenty of time here. Wright sliding in with the reception and will be a first down in OSU territory at 36-yard line.
Kendall Wright stuff. I mean, he has made the right stuff. This kid will compete. And that's, you know, I think that's the thing, you know, that Art Browse has to, in the big picture, be proud that his football team is competing at a higher level.
Wright, one of three receivers nationally to have 50 or more receptions in each of the last three seasons. So talk about consistency. Young man from Pittsburgh, Texas has certainly lived up to that. The second and 10, or second and about 11 here.
A catch in 34 straight football games. Reliability, accountability, those are good abilities to have.
Gannaway, the carry here, cuts it right back up, keeps his balance, and he'll score.
Yes.
So Terrence Gannaway gashes through the OSU defense, and the Bears, with 20 second half points, just have had no answer to stop the guys in orange, but they've gotten their offense going.
And Bill Young is going to have concerns with, that's the second time that up the middle of the football field, and his defense has been gashed right in its underbelly. And they do a good job of cutting off in the backside, giving a lane for Gannaway, and he takes it to the house.
And the point after by Jones is up. Aaron Jones' kick is good. So Gannaway with a 28-yard TD run, and Baylor makes it 48-21. Gannaway with his touchdown, making it 48-21 following the PAT, as Oklahoma State comfortably ahead here. Brandon Weeden, Kendall Hunter, and Justin Blackmon, the latest set of triplets here for Oklahoma State. And take a look at today. Weeden needing just a few more yards to pass Zach Robinson for the single game passing record. And Blackmon, a touchdown, 69 yards rushing. Hunter, it's like a day off for Hunter.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, Weeden is gonna have five of the top 11 single game passing marks already in an abbreviated career at this point.
And the kick comes back to Oklahoma State. And watch out, we may get a one all the way for the distance here as the Cowboys go end to end. Touchdown, Oklahoma State.
Justin Gilbert.
Justin Gilbert takes it 92 yards.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable. I mean, Oklahoma State has had three kickoff returns against them this season. They get their first one in the return game themselves. And Murphy's Law is officially in full effect for Baylor. What can go wrong will go wrong. They get out of their coverage lanes. Justin Gilbert finds the crease, and he is off to the races. He scores in touch football. Nobody laid a fingernail on him.
So officially now they're saying 93 yards for Justin Gilbert. Wow. As Oklahoma State, Bailey comes out, knocks it through. And the Cowboys, 55-21. Well, Oklahoma State has walked the dog on Baylor today, as 55-21, and the Cowboys kick it off again. And returning the football, Odom, the 25, brought down there. And it'll be Baylor ball with 8:34 remaining in the game, 24 yards on the return.
Boy, you look at when you get an unscripted score, either a defensive or a special team score, it's usually significant. But honestly, it wasn't that significant at this point because the game was already in control of Oklahoma State. But just pouring salt on the wound, it's amazing.
The 93-yard kickoff return, it was almost a ho-hum. Oh, Jesus, he scored again.
Yeah.
Griffin rolls out here. Incomplete. Trying to hook up with Tevin Reese. Second down and 10. First and 10 line is brought to you by Phillips Televisions.
You know, Bill, I think a lot of people are going to say, Baylor, you know, they couldn't handle success. You know, they've won three straight conference games, two on the road, big one in Austin, Texas, getting a lot of attaboys, pats on the back, and they forgot how they got there with all the hard work. I don't think Art Briles has got to let that happen. They just got beaten.
Yeah, let's talk about, as this one is caught across the middle by Williams, how about Oklahoma State?
Yeah.
Ready to play.
Right.
Brought the wood and put it on them. And right, not only from the beginning, but the play to start the second half just took anything out of Baylor of any hope of a major comeback.
And I think Justin Blackmon, getting him back, it's like getting a first round draft choice to your football team.
I mean, they survived Kansas State. Good, solid effort. Kendall Wright on the receiving end here. And a lot of guys picked it up. And I think that gave Oklahoma State even more confidence that, hey, we can win on the road without maybe the best receiver in the country.
Yep.
Look what we can do now that he's back.
And Brandon Weeden grew up as a quarterback last week without that guy. Without his you know, security blanket. But yeah, they certainly plus three in the turnover department. That was big.
Take a look at that just again or in a moment on the completion here.
Well, why are they up so big? Three takeaways, three touchdowns. That'll do it. Touchdowns on 6 of 12 drives. Some of those have been in the red zone. You know, that dog will hunt right there. And hidden yards, that has been the biggest deal. I mean, and plus they took one back for a touchdown in terms of special teams. So the yards weren't so hidden. I mean, special teams have dominated the Cowboys. Cowboys have dominated the last game.
Baylor on the ground here on the first and 10 situation. And the Bears coming in here 7-2, 4-1. And two games remaining after this, they go home to meet Texas A&M, and that'll be part of our college football Saturday package in the Big 12 next Saturday night. And then they finish up with Oklahoma. This one is incomplete. Whereas the Cowboys have got Texas in Austin next week, then they've got Kansas, and then they play, of course, the Bedlam game on Thanksgiving weekend. So, as we've said before, obviously OSU excited to come out of here staying with just one loss. OSU could then move in. Well, you could move into a tie with a win tonight against A&M, but Baylor's not out of it. It's not how much you lose by. If they can bounce back, and the way things have gone in this season anyway, you'd almost expect something weird to happen by the end of the year anyway.
Yeah, I mean, the only thing you know is you better not count your chickens before they hatch, that's for sure. And Art Briles, will his football team be able to rebound? They don't want to turn one bad performance into two. You know, compartmentalize this one, get over it, and move on. And every week is a new week. They just have to get over it and you know, just erase it from their memory bank.
Fourth and three here, flag thrown as OSU appeared jumped, and they'll hold things up as Griffin.
Now Brad Taylor jumped too. Are they going to say the tight end moved before the defensive lineman did? Who caused whose movement first? Did Taylor respond to the defense? Let's see how they sort it out, because both sides of the line of scrimmage moved, but who was the initiator? It was Oklahoma State by jumping in the neutral zone. And for Oklahoma State's standpoint, okay, did a lot of good things against Baylor. You go down to Austin next week, Mike Gundy's going to say, hey, guys, this game's over. We don't get to go down to Austin and take some of these 55 points with us. We have to start all over again. So last week is last week. I mean, we're on the road against a football team that's going to be, you know, bring in their A game. This is going to be their qualification for their bowl opportunity. So, I mean, both coaches have their own challenges for sure next week.
And talk this one over here with 6:23 to go. Yeah.
Dead ball. Offside. Defense. 5-yard penalty. Yardage gives them an automatic first down.
So Baylor will move the chains, keep possession here, first and 10 at the 36-yard line. Oklahoma State picked for near the bottom in the preseason poll, going 7-1 coming in here today. Will be 8-1 and 4-1 after this one. Finley with a Salubi, beg your pardon, right down the sideline into the end zone, but a flag thrown.
Yeah, this is a hold on Robert T. Griffin. He got his money's worth, and he just absolutely took linebacker to the ground, Tyler Johnson to the ground. I mean, he just take that.
Offense, number 59.
Watkins.
Oh, Watkins. I thought it was 79. My bad. But Watkins came around the horn, pulled from the left guard position, and took him to the turf.
Brings back the touchdown.
Had a rough game. He's had false start penalties and now holding. He's had a good season. He's had a very, very solid season at operating up front. They've been very physical in their offensive line up front. Has not been a good day today for the boys up front.
So first and 20 now from the 48 and incomplete. You know, we're talking about OSU and 666 yards of offense, 55 points. Mike Gundy beforehand talking about how his team has handled success.
And offensively, you have Weeden, who's 27. Kendall doesn't talk. And you have four new linemen that are just trying to keep their head above water each week. And so it's really worked out in our favor that they're just playing. They're not really worried about anything else.
That'll always work, particularly when those offensive linemen just trying to keep your head above water. No one wants to drown. Yeah, you don't want to drown out there.
Pass complete to Sampson, and he gets out of bounds, stops the clock at the 31.
I'd love to play for Mike Gundy if I'm a young football player. I mean, that guy's a lot of fun. You know, he knows the game. He's got a great coaching staff. They have tremendous facilities here, as nice as any facilities anywhere in the country. And he's got it going on. I mean, they're what? They'll be 25-9 now in their last, or 26-9 in the last 35 games.
Yeah, pretty remarkable the way they've built it up here. Griffin going to the end zone. And while we're talking with Gundy, what about how his defense has handled the success of the team overall?
Well, it's worked out well for us because Ori Lemon is mature and he's been around here, so he understands it. Hugo Chinas is really laid back, doesn't say anything. He's done a good job with it. Our two safeties, Markel and Johnny, who are our other leaders, and then Broderick Brown, the corner, they've played enough to where they know how to handle it. The young players that are competing on defense, they don't have a clue what's going on. I mean, they really don't. And it's worked to their advantage because they don't really get caught up in it because they don't understand.
Keep it simple. They have. This one complete to Sampson as Baylor still firing. It'll be a first and 10 inside the 20.
You know, when you have a bunch of young guys that don't know what they don't know, it's good to have a guy like Bill Young teaching them to know something, you know? I mean, you spend a year with Bill Young, and you're not young anymore. He advances you. You know, you get out of those early stages, the elementary school stages, and, you know, pretty soon you're understanding football.
Well, their team young as this one can away and knocked out of bounds, but they had a little bit of experience, but they felt that if they didn't have too many critical injuries, that the talent is certainly here, and it has been developed over the course of the year. So they're not really surprised here in Stillwater that they're going to be 8-1 and leading the Big 12 South at 4-1. But things have fallen into place, and you give credit to the players and the staff for following the plan. Ganaway, not much of a gain, down near the 12.
There's two phases to it, Bill, in building a program. Recruiting players and then developing them. You have to evaluate the talent, and then once you develop, you recruit that talent, develop that talent.
And guys, kudos to Mike Gundy for taking on a different role. You bring in Dana Holgerson, and he made no qualms about the fact that if he was going to come in, he was going to be calling the shots, and Gundy's definitely benefited from that.
You're right. He said it's made him not only a better football coach, but a better person. You know, I mean, he's probably, as Bill Young has said, he's as good a football head coach as there is in the country.
Burke, the receiver on that play. In the past, if you're not aware, Gundy, of course, was calling the plays and saying, boy, that just took so much time to prepare.
Right.
Now he's handling everything in the program, kind of stepped back, and it's paid off. Here's Ganaway for another touchdown for Baylor. So, you know, Baylor's going to come out of here and go, all right, we kept plugging away, And offensively, I mean, that's now 27 points in the second half.
Again, Art Briles, his football team will not spit the bit. They run the counterplay. Look at the backside linemen fit and finish their blocks. That's outstanding execution. Right guard, right tackle. Nice job.
4:09 to go. The kick is good once again. And Baylor gets its fourth score of the day, 55-28. OSU. Here's our man for the Whataburger. What a play, Justin Blackmon. First play from scrimmage, second half.
I'll tell you, it's just an outstanding effort when he gets the ball in space. And heard a lot about him. It's the first opportunity to see him. No question he is special. I mean, he is just aware of everything that goes on around him in the football field. Tremendous route runner, and he's got some wheels.
Woo!
I mean, that's cooking, that's burning now.
And for the moment, he's their leading rusher on the day with 69 yards. Randall has 67, and Kendall Hunter has 66.
And he's averaged 69 a run.
Yeah, thank you. Well, your bath is good. Here is Justin Gilbert, who took the last one 93 yards. And he is thrown down back at the forward progress stop to the 26, Justin Blackmon. But look at that afternoon, 173, 69, 242, and a couple of touchdowns.
Responsible for almost 2.5 football fields and a couple of scores. That doggle hunt, and you factor in, he dropped the 45-yarder. I mean, he'd be at 287 and 3 touchdowns. Unrealism, that's productivity.
So Brandon Weeden comes on, and Weeden with 4 yards will set a single game passing record, passing Zach Robinson on a 1st and 10 here, and he completes it. And that ought to do it, is Chelf, who's got a touchdown reception earlier today as well.
They're gonna take him out after setting the record.
Yep, fans recognize it, Brandon Weeden.
Amazing.
Junior from Edmond, Oklahoma, out of Santa Fe High School, the 27-year-old quarterback. Continue to put up phenomenal numbers, and there you see it, 433 yards and 3 touchdowns with no picks.
Well, he was completing 2 out of every 3 passes coming into this football game, and today he completed 3 out of every 4. He's even better.
And now Klinkchop comes in, hands it off. Here's Randall, and Randall is tackled out of bounds at the 46-yard line, so he's going to replace Blackmon as the leading rusher.
Well, this Oklahoma State offense is like watching a world-class relay team. Instead of handing off a baton, they're handing off a football. I mean, it is unbelievable. Dana Holgorsen spreads the field, makes you defend the entire football field against the run and the pass.
Paulson comes in now to set up as a late addition to the lineup. And the handoff to Jeremy Smith, and Smith takes it inside the 40. We talked a lot about the triplets. It goes back a ways to Gundy, Dykes, and Sanders back in 88. Of course, Sanders winning the Heisman Trophy. How about Josh Fields, Rashawn Woods, and Tatum Bell, the 0-2 triplets? And then Robinson, who just had that record broken, Dez Bryant now with the Cowboys, Dallas, and Kendall Hunter from 2 years ago. And of course, this bunch.
Yeah.
OSU now 702 yards of offense with a 2nd and 1 coming.
That's a lot of triples.
Here's Smith. He breaks it out to the 25, the 24-yard line. Remember their offense mark this year, 722 against Tulsa.
You know, I'm thinking 3,500 yards passing is probably not enough for Weeden. He'll probably go 4,000. I mean, he could. And 1,500 yards receiving is not enough for Blackmon. And 1,500 yards rushing would be a good goal, you know, for Kendall Hunter. He rushed for 1,555 2 years ago. But they'd be the first school in college football history to go for 3,500 at the quarterback position, 1,500 receiver and runner.
Here is Smith again as he takes it down to inside the 20.
The team that came the closest to doing those numbers, USC, Matt Leinart was well over 3,500 yards. Reggie Bush had like 1,800 plus rushing. And Jarrett, the receiver, was just short. He had 1,200 yards receiving. And normally when you have a guy throwing, you know, for all those yards, you don't necessarily have a running back that goes for 1,500. It's dynamic how balanced and diverse and versatile this offense is.
Well, they're about to set a total offense record. They need 2 yards to pass or to tie the Tulsa mark of 722. And Chelf with a rollout looking in the end zone and incomplete. Brought down outside of play as nearly intercepted.
And it's amazing watching this offense last week against Kansas State. This offense without Blackmon and this offense with Blackmon, man, it's like having a Mercedes that doesn't have the engine. I mean, Blackmon makes a huge, huge difference because he attracts so much attention, he opens opportunities up for everybody else. And Dana Horgelson knows exactly what he's got going on.
Blackman's already at the fourth highest single season total for OSU with games to go. As he sits out here, Smith with the run and stopped at the 19-yard line. We're inside the final minute of play. As Phil Taylor in on the play.
Well, Phil just running the football field. That's a long day at the office for the big fella. He's been out there a lot of snaps. His cardio is light years better than last season. He lost weight, got himself in a lot better shape, and he'll sleep well tonight.
So Oklahoma State needs two more yards still to break the all-time total offensive mark with 19 seconds to go and counting. This would be the last snap most likely, and there it is. They do break that record as on that carry, taking it down to the 15-yard line. And Jeremy Smith makes it 724 yards of total offense.
Calm down, boys. Calm down. You don't want this to happen.
No.
I know tempers are short now, but calm it down. Both benches are starting to empty. The game's over. Let's just shake hands and say, you know, good effort by everybody.
And total offense mark breaks the previous one set against Tulsa earlier this season.
And they're saying they were trying to get the coaches off the field. The clock was still running, but already Gundy and Art Briles shaking hands. And Art Briles talking to the officials. And game's over. They wanted to run one more snap, talked to both coaches, said, you want to do it? And they're like, let's call it a day.
We've had enough fun. Certainly Art Briles is ready to head back to Waco and get back to the drawing board and find out how A&M comes out against Oklahoma tonight. That'll be the next opponent for Robert Griffin. Tough, tough day for a guy that had started to get some Heisman talk. But after today, and it changes every week, people got to be looking at what's going on here at Oklahoma State,
yeah.
Whether it is Weeden, whether it is Hunter, or certainly Justin Blackmon. All three of those guys are just incredible performers.
Do they split votes?
I mean,
do they take votes away from each other when you have all this talent? I mean, it's kind of interesting, but I do think that when you look at the numbers they're putting up on the board, you have to start to consider maybe one or all of them.
Certainly they'll be up for awards at their positions.
Yeah.
Let's go down now to Emily Jones.
Thank you very much, Coach Gundy. A record-setting performance from your offense today. Things seem to be clicking on all cylinders.
Well, our players really competed today, and I thought the coaches had a really good plan,
right.
And the players gave us great effort. And for the most part, we took care of the football. And it got to a certain point where we were just able to execute, and some days everything works, and today was one of those days.
Brandon Weeden having a phenomenal season, and nice to get Justin Blackmon back in the fold. Proud of the way he bounced back.
Well, Blackmon had a tough week a week ago, and the only way to go is to bounce back and give great effort, and he plays extremely hard, and I was proud of Brandon. I was really proud of our defense, though. I mean, when you look at where we're at now, you know, they give up 14, you know, until we start subbing. I was really proud of our defense.
Yeah, talk about the game plan that Bill Young had, especially in the first half, to shut them out.
Well, we really felt like that number 10 had thrown the ball really well down the field, and we needed to defend that much, much more than anything else, just to stop those big plays. They were getting a lot of big plays in the last few games. So we just felt like we had to stop the big plays.
I know you coaches always like to talk about how it starts up front. It seemed like you dominated the lines of scrimmage.
Well, I was very proud of our offensive line. I think they blocked really well. And our defensive line did a good job of using their hands and shedding blocks and making plays on the running game.
Mike Gundy, thanks so much. We appreciate the time. Congratulations on the win. Bill, we'll send it back up to you.
All right, thank you, Emily. Officially 725 yards of total offense for the new Oklahoma State record. Yeah. And let's send it right back to Emily, who's got Brandon Weeden with her now.
Yeah, that's right. The record books tend to be rewritten around here on a weekly basis. Brandon Weeden, 433 yards, three touchdowns, no picks. Just talk about your day today.
You know, we had some success. You know, Baylor's a good football team, and they mixed up their looks and put pressure on me. And you know, the guys on the outside and the guys up front did a great job. You know, it's a good record to have. But I mean, I tell you what. All my credit goes to those guys out there that are busting their butts.
It seemed like it works. It's working underneath. It's working down the field. When you've got a guy like Justin Blackmon, that underneath stuff tends to open up a little bit more.
Yeah, no question. You know, he can stretch the field vertically, and which opens up stuff underneath, like you just said. And, you know, it was nice having Justin Black. You know, I know he's happy to be back. He fights hard as a competitor. But, you know, we had some other guys step up and made a lot of catches today. And, you know, that's what this offense is all about is spreading the ball around and letting those guys make plays. And today we had some success doing it.
There's been a few sets of triplets here at Oklahoma State. Now you guys are making yourselves into your own version. Are you comfortable with that?
Absolutely. You know, just to be mentioned with those other guys, I mean, just it's a great accomplishment. And we know we're not satisfied. We want to keep plugging along.
Yeah, then finally, one more. Just talk about that, the fact that you can't, you know, can't take any of these points with you next week. Just talk about keeping focused and wanting to finish this regular season out.
Yeah, no question. You know, I mean, we're going to celebrate this one tonight, but come tomorrow, we're going to put it behind us. You know, we got a big one against Texas next week at Texas. So, you know, we're going to enjoy this right now, but we got to focus come Monday.
Brandon, we appreciate the time. Congratulations on the performance today. Today, Bill and Dave, we'll send it back to you.
All right, thanks, Emily. Boy, complete manhandling from Oklahoma State. Yeah. Baylor gets 28 points, but the game was well decided by the time they got on the board.
And I like Brandon Weeden's comment that it starts up front, because it does. His offensive line opened up running lanes, gave him opportunity to throw the football. If they don't do their job up front, it doesn't matter who you have at the skill positions, nothing's going to work. And he knows where it starts, and he's a smart quarterback to give kudos to those guys, because I'll tell you what, Coach Wickline, tip a cap to you and your boys up front, heck of a job.
No question about that. As Oklahoma State improves, they're the leader for the moment of the Big 12 South. Coming up later, eighth-ranked Oklahoma against Texas A&M in the Big 12. That'll be followed by Arizona State going against Southern Cal in a Pac-10 showdown. Now for Dave Lapham, Emily Jones, and our entire College Football Saturday crew, this is Bill Land saying so long from Stillwater, where the Cowboys ride to a romp.
A record-setting day in Stillwater, Oklahoma. And what is it that our friend and colleague Bill Land says? Whoa, mama! What a day offensively for the Oklahoma State Cowboys. 55-28 the final. 725 yards of offense for the Cowboys. A record-setting day and an unbelievable way for them to establish supremacy in the Big 12 South. Hi there. Welcome into the Toyota Big 12 postgame show. John Radigan here. Pat Jones, Corby Jones, Gary Reasons, and the question, I guess, is, has the clock struck midnight on the Cinderella story of the Baylor Bears? Or after gaining bowl eligibility, coach, and then beating Texas, maybe just didn't have anything left in the tank?
Well, you start trying to get in this comparative score stuff, and I know locked in my mind was that TCU had beaten them 45-10. TCU slaughtered them earlier in the year, and you thought, well, Baylor's gotten better, which they have. Griffith's having a big year, which he is. Now they go up here, and Oklahoma State really turns it on, knocks them in the head again. Yes, it was a surprise, not that Oklahoma State won, but the magnitude.
Oh, I agree. I mean, to be that disproportionate, I mean, that was what was so shocking. We knew that the offense would show up for Oklahoma State. We knew that both teams might have a hard time on defense, but Baylor's offense never seemed to get going. And, you know, guys, when you look at it, I mean, I hate to count off those guys in Norman, but Oklahoma State may be the team to beat.
Yeah, Oklahoma State, I thought they did a great job of containing Robert Griffin early in the ball game. A couple of turnovers, a couple of fumbles by Baylor really set the table for Oklahoma State. They got 14 points off of turnovers in the first half. So I think that Baylor playing from behind wasn't a place they wanted to play, especially in a hostile environment up in Stillwater. It was a great day for the Cowboys.
You've got to take advantage of those turnovers. They did that, and they did it in unbelievable fashion. Take a look at the offensive numbers by the big three, as it were, the triplets, if you will. Brandon Weeden sets a record today with those 438 yards, and he only had 8 incompletions, and I can remember 2 or 3 drops among those incompletions. Justin Blackmon with the huge day receiving and 1 for 69 in rushing. Kendall Hunter, I guess maybe numbers down a little, but he had 2 touchdowns. They didn't need him for any more than those 66 yards. So it was a heck of a day offensively for the Oklahoma State Cowboys. Let's take you right back out there to Stillwater, Oklahoma, and get a wrap-up of this one from Bill Land and Dave Lapham.
All right, thanks very much, fellas. What a day here in Stillwater, and I don't know if we're going to highlight some guy. You got to go through the whole football team at Oklahoma State because they all had an impact, but particularly significant, I think, for Justin Blackmon because being suspended, missing the game at Kansas State, and they win without him, but boy, are they a bunch better with him.
Well, seeing how competitive he is, he must have died 1,000 deaths not being able to play last week against Kansas State, because this guy will compete for every single football. He has got so much going on. Look at how long his arms are. He has got tremendous length. He's only 6'1", but he plays a lot bigger than that because of the length. And he catches everything, and he catches it with very, very soft hands. He runs precise routes. He's very aware of where he is in the football field and coverage presented to him. And then why not give it to him on a little reverse end around and give it to him in space and let his teammates block a little bit and go 69 yards for a touchdown. He got one receiving, he got one rushing, and a little Stillwater leap, and the fans love Justin Blackmon, and he loves them too. Look at those numbers. Unbelievable.
13 for 173, the 69-yard touchdown run. And you take all that, and the fact they set a total offense record, a single-game passing record for Weeden as a quarterback. The defense sent a little message in the first half when the game was in doubt that, hey, they've come to play and they're ready, and that should be a heck of a battle down in Austin next week.
We talked about what was the key to the game, which defense would step up, not make mistakes, and make plays. Oklahoma State in the first half, 3 takeaways, 3 touchdowns for their offense. That was huge.
All right, for Dave Lapham, Bill Land, we'll send it back to you.
All right, guys, thanks very much. The numbers are staggering. They almost don't fit on our stat board. I guess officially 724 yards of total offense, those 438 passing yards from Brandon Weeden. The rushing total, unbelievable for the Oklahoma State Cowboys as well. Just about every statistical category, they were pretty dominant, especially those offensive categories. And Corby, Brandon Weeden, I mean, we didn't know exactly what we had in this young man at the beginning of the season. He seems to get better every week.
He does, guys. He came into this game first in the league in passing yards, second in total offense, and third in passing efficiency. So this wasn't a flash in the pan. This kid has been doing it every single week. He's a pretty special player.
I think Mike Gundy touched on this earlier when he said in the last month, Weeden's really gotten better. Again, he's older than Brett Favre, but the guy has improved, and he's got a touch. He's got a very live ball, and, you know, if you just ask going in, who would be the all-league quarterback, I would have probably said Robert Griffin before the game. Now I think it's probably Weeden.
Yeah, Robert Griffin and both Brandon Weeden, you know, coming into this ballgame, we thought it would be a great matchup. But obviously, it kind of just fell in the favor of Oklahoma State in this one. Brandon Weeden had a great game. Robert Griffin, his longest completion today, guys, 19 yards, no touchdown passes.
Yeah, good job by that Oklahoma State defense. We will talk about them and how they created those turnovers a little later on in the program. We're working on some more post-game reaction and analysis, too. It's the Toyota Big 12 post-game show. We're just getting started. Lots of highlights from Stillwater coming your way, too. Stay with us.
The Toyota Big 12 post-game.
Take a look at how this one played out in Stillwater, Oklahoma. Robert Griffin and the Baylor Bears driving. Josh Gordon has it. Ball is stripped away. Oklahoma State recovers, and at that point, the route really was on. First and goal, Oklahoma State. Weeden lofts it into the end zone. Justin Blackmon, great catch. Is it a better catch or throw, Corby?
Guys, you know me. I'm always going to side with the QB. Where else are you going to throw that ball?
That's a great pass. 10-0 at that point. Weeden going deep to Justin Blackmon here. He's got to wait for it, but he catches it and then gets a few extra yards. A little extra effort there, Gary.
Yeah, just that's what he did all day long. Just showed he came up big in every
passer of the game, running the ball and receiving.
Didn't need Kendall Hunter to rush for too many yards, but he was effective when he did it. The one-yard touchdown there to make it 17-0. 24-0 Baylor trying to get into this football game, and there comes the defense. Johnny Thomas intercepts the ball for the touchback. We're in the third quarter now, and a little trickery to start the thing off. The fake handoff, the fake lateral, and then a little flip to Justin Blackmon. He's got some speed, too, Coach.
Blackmon, when he gets strung out, he can run. He's such a tall, long-legged guy. He can move quicker than people think he can.
69 yards for that touchdown to make it 31-0 in our Whataburger play of the day. Baylor kicking off after their third touchdown, and Justin Gilbert just returns it, takes it right up the middle, and takes it to the house. 92 yards as the Cowboys score in virtually every way imaginable. 55-21 at that point. 55-28 the final. The Oklahoma State Cowboys just put a whooping on the Baylor Bears, and it wasn't as close as 55-28 might indicate, as strange as that might sound. A 55-28, though, a thrashing today by the Oklahoma State Cowboys in a matchup of the top two teams in the Big 12 South Division coming into the game. Our Phillips defining play of the game is that little trickery we showed you to start off the third quarter. It's a heck of a call to get the third quarter started, Corby.
Oh, gosh, man. Like Coach said, this guy can do it all. And those DBs don't really want to get in his way either. That's a lot of man running very fast.
It is, and they didn't. Nobody could slow him down. Nobody did get into his way. And so it leaves a pretty interesting picture as we take a look at the Big 12 South now. And in some ways, Gary, it almost sets up for, depending on what happens tonight in College Station, but it could well set up for a very important Bedlam game between Oklahoma and Oklahoma State later on this season.
It's always a fun game, no matter what. But that game really has an opportunity to be the game for the Big 12 South and perhaps the Big 12 championship. But the schedules, you know, for Baylor, you know, they've got two more conference games left. They'd like to get things going well to finish the season strong. And obviously, it just did not go for them. They've got Texas A&M next weekend, and obviously, they've got Oklahoma as well on the schedule. So a little more barking, I think, from the Bears. You'll hear that some more this season. Hopefully, they can get back in sync with what they're able to do offensively and put up a little better defensive effort than we saw today.
The Oklahoma State schedule, they've actually got three games left on their schedule at Texas next week in Austin. Now, the Longhorns play tonight up in Manhattan, Kansas, so we don't know what kind of mood they'll be in, but they've been struggling, obviously, by the record there, 4-4. Then at Kansas, a team that's really struggling this year, but that really could set up Bedlam for a huge game. Coach, you've been a part of that.
Well, and two, now, you remember, we saw Kendall Hunter run wild in Austin 2 years ago, you know, against a better Texas team than what they're playing right now. So that really sets up, depending on what happens with Texas later on this evening. This is a huge ball game, but, you know, just like anything else, you get into the stretch run, and when you're winning, every one of them just becomes bigger and bigger and bigger. It could go all the way to the wire.
Wonder about Justin Blackmon just a little bit. He had to sit out last week. We all know about, you know, he went to the Monday night game, the Dallas Cowboys game, to watch his former teammate Dez Bryant. He sat out last week for team suspension. Does he come back maybe with a little extra today?
I think he came back hungry, but again, it's hard to say if he's an expert or not, because the guy does it every game he plays. You saw the numbers. He had 173 yards receiving today, but actually turned that into 218 because he tacked on three pass interference penalties. So, and then he dropped a 45-yard touchdown also. So the kid could have had over 250 yards receiving today.
Yeah, unbelievable watching that kid play. He really got it done, and so did the Oklahoma State Cowboys today. We've got lots more coming up on the Toyota Big 12 postgame show. I'm seeing. Hey, here's the Toyota drive of the game. Starts in the first quarter, Oklahoma State, Brandon Weeden, Joseph Randall. It's good for 12 yards, and then they switch ends for the second quarter. Weeden with all day finds a wide open Justin Blackmon. That's the one that went for 38 yards, and it set up the Kendall Hunter finish of the drive, a one-yard touchdown. 80 plays, 80 yards, 2 minutes and 53 seconds, our Toyota drive of the game. Welcome for our steel power player of the game, and there were a lot of choices, but we've settled on Brandon Weeden for his record-setting day. 438 yards through the air and 724 in total offense. Both of those are records at Oklahoma State. Brandon Weeden, our steel power player of the day. Welcome back to the Toyota Big 12 postgame show. John Rapp.